expected them to. So I think I'm going to go with Cincinnati in that one, though.
First of all, I love the breakdowns. Bengals plus +5, the last I saw. What do you think? Antoine, I'm big on Lou Anarumo and his defense. I thought the Bengals defense had a lot of trouble. What was going on with them defensively? And are there any concerns for you on that side of the ball?
Man, I think obviously they're going to go back and look at film. Again, it's tough, you know, watching the game as far as, you know, what's going on, you know, some miscommunication. Obviously, I think with the defense, the best thing is for everybody to be on the same page. But again, you know, they've done some good things this year. He's been leading that defense, and they've been able to help that team get to where they at. I think some concerns as far as the offensive line for the Cincinnati Bengals. You know, early in the year they have some concerns. They tighten it up a little bit, you know, mid season and towards later of the season. But with, you know, left tackle might being out, you know, you can put some, you know, circle that as far as potentially being a problem, but it's going to be a good game, man. You know, Joe Burrow, great young quarterback, Joe Cool, man. So, again, I think I'm going to lean with the Bengals.
I get that. I love Joe Cool. One last thought. Antoine, did you see Joey Bosa go in on the officials? Have you seen that video or heard that audio? I mean, he just lit these dudes on fire, and that was after a long cool-down period. Is he right, and is the officiating that big of an issue right now?
Man, the officiating, it does have to be addressed. You know, I know they go through their preseason training as far as things to be the focal points of the season, but it has to be addressed. You know, where players, when the players on the field make mistakes, whether it's a penalty, whether it's whatever the case may be, they either get fined for it or, you know, it's talked about. And we talk about the shield and protecting the shield. The referees are part of that, so they got to be held accountable, just like everybody else. You know, coaches involved, you know, front office, everybody has to be held to a high standard because this is the NFL shield. And, I don't think Bosa was wrong being able to express the way he felt about the refs. Obviously, you know, there's been some questionable calls during the year and in the playoffs. So, hey, you know, voice your opinion. So, but the refs do need to be held accountable.
He is a 14-year NFL safety, a Super Bowl champion. He's got 3 rings. He is the author of Bet on Yourself, Inside the Mind of the Ultimate Underdog, co-host of an excellent pod, the Man to Man pod, Antoine Bethea, closing the show for me. Antoine, appreciate you, AB. Thank you very much. Great to have you back on. Always good to talk to you.
Man, appreciate you. Take care.
Appreciate you, dude. Be good. That's fun. James Kelly, I know you loved his breakdown for the weekend. For the ones who get it done, Grainger is offering supplies and solutions for every industry, as well as access to product experts ready to answer your toughest questions. Call or click Grainger.com or stop on by. You know, thumbnail sketch, the underdog that he picked was Bengals. He took all the other favorites. Another great weekend of games, and they are tough to call. My thanks to Antoine Bethea, Steve Peichel, Rutgers head coach. As long as they did a pretty nice job, you can always do better. Thank you for listening. Have an amazing day. See you tomorrow. We're out. The NFL playoff action continues, and we are one step closer to Super Bowl 57. And for the NFL divisional round, check out DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of the NFL. New customers can bet just $5 and get 200 in free bets instantly. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app. Use the code ROME. New customers can bet $5 on the NFL divisional round and get 200 in free bets instantly. That's code ROME, only at DraftKings Sportsbook. Must be present in state where lawful to wager. 21 or older in most eligible states, but age varies by jurisdiction. Eligibility restrictions do apply. See DraftKings.com/sportsbook for details and state-specific responsible gambling resources. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. In New York, call 877-8-HOPE-NY or text HOPE-NY-467-369. Void in Ohio and Ontario. Bonus issued as free bets. 1 boost per eligible game. Opt-in required. 10-plus leg required for 100% boost. Deposit, parlay, and wagering restrictions do apply. Eligibility and terms at sportsbook.draftkings.com/football terms.
I'm Donald Stocks, owner of Pip Marketing Signs Print. We are your one-stop shop for just about anything printed. If we're not your go-to printer, please give us a call at 355-1636. We have over 80 five-star Google reviews and want you to be our next more than satisfied and well-pleased customer. Check us out at growitpip.com or stop in to see us at 3185 Mosley Drive in Greenville. PIP, where business goes to grow.
Country Mart has been locally owned and operated for over 40 years and is your premier country store serving the best cheese biscuits and country food around. Country Mart is open every day and has two locations in Bethel on Highway 11 and in Stokes on Highway 903. Both Country Mart locations are top-of-the-line fuel stations serving Shell gas, including 93 ethanol-free high-octane gas. Country Mart, fueling you up with great food in your engines with great gasoline. Go Pirates!
Hey, Pirate Nation, Lindsey Gray here with Carolina Caliber. In 1960, my granddaddy started his firearm business right here in Eastern NC. Still family owned and operated, we have the area's largest selection for outdoor shooting sports and accessories and are one of the nation's top firearm dealers. At Carolina Caliber, we have everything you need from hunting, home defense, and personal protection, including a wide variety for ladies and youth. We buy, sell, and trade. It's a time-honored tradition. Visit us at Carolina Caliber on Fire Tower Road in Winterville.
Jeff Stein, our special guest from Brown & Wood. Hey, Jeff, electric cars are coming. What's that mean for Brown & Wood customers?
For the customers, like it or not, EV is coming. We've installed 5 electric vehicle chargers here at the dealership. We have the all-new Cadillac Lyriq coming first of 2024, and we've just seen the first reservation for the new Sierra EV.
People are interested in electric vehicles. How can they get up with you?
They can visit us at brownandwood.net or 329 Southwest Greenville Boulevard. Brown & Wood, 4 brands, 3 generations, 2 rooftops, and 1 goal. To make sure you leave a happy customer.
At Jimmy John's, we don't make sandwiches. We make the sandwich of sandwiches. We use fresh veggies because we don't hate salads. We just feel bad for them. We make our sandwiches exactly how you want because you're the one who's eating it. And we bake bread all day, every day because stale bread isn't bread. It's croutons. Sandwich history is written by the victors. Good thing we have legible handwriting. Jimmy John's, the sandwich of sandwiches. Order pickup or delivery on the app.
With over 30 locations across North Carolina and Southeastern Virginia, Quality Equipment is your local John Deere dealer, where you'll find everything you need for your next project. Our complete lineup of John Deere lawn and garden, agricultural, and commercial worksite equipment comes with years of experience, expertise, and dedication. We know what it takes to get it done right. Stop by today or visit us online at qualityequip.com.
It's bow time. You've probably heard folks say, don't call it a comeback. But at Bojangles, we don't like to beat around the bush. So when the sizzling, savory pork chop griller's back in all its tender, marinated chili lime glory, and you can get a pork chop griller combo for just $4.59, go ahead, call it a comeback. Get a legendary pork chop griller combo for just $4.59, only at Bojangles. It's bow time.
If you missed Pirate Radio Live, you missed.
How many fourth graders do you think you can beat up at one time? For Noah Anderson, that's got to be a pretty big number.
Yeah, so you've got all these fourth graders coming at you. How many could you take care of?
Got a couple on the legs, a couple around.
Before what? They bring them like down to the ground?
Yeah, I guess
they
get so. To, like, yeah. Bring
what's
me
the
down?
End game?
Yeah. Fourth graders? Kids are getting big now.
They are getting bigger.
I might can take it like 25 to 30.
I'd put the over under 20 at least.
Yeah. All right, we've got 25. Bring it in.
Pirate Radio Live, weekdays from 3 to 6, right here on Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation. This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930 and 104.1 FM Washington.
Can you be quiet, please? Thank you.
Welcome to Pirate Radio Live.
Well, I just think we were prepared. You know, one thing my trainer, he told me, he said, what did he say? He just told us to be prepared.
All right.
Ty?
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 I want me some glory hole.
Dude. You ain't moss. I'm the boss.
Coca Hornets.
It's me, Amanda Garcia.
I'm sorry.
How about those friggin' pirates?
Now live from the Pirate Radio Studios in the heart of the Pirate Nation, here is your host, Clip Brock.
Welcome in to a Tuesday edition of Pirate Radio Live. Clip Brock here, a gray, drizzly day in Greenville, North Carolina. We got a lot of news and notes to get to on today's program regarding ECU athletics, and we'll hit those momentarily on Pirate Radio 92.7 FM in Greenville, 104.1 in Washington. You can find us on 1250-930, also online, pr927fm.com, and watch the show on Facebook Live and YouTube. Chime in with what is on your mind on this Tuesday afternoon. Coming up at 4 o'clock, Mully will join us. We'll talk about what's going on in the world of sports, and especially here locally around these parts. Bryce Williams joins us in the 5 o'clock hour. We'll go Pirate Radio Outdoors, talk NFL playoffs and more with Bryce Williams coming up at 5 o'clock. Shirley Rhodes is here. Chandler Honeycutt is here. Jonathan Ellerby to my left. Hello, Ellerby.
Clipper, how are you doing today?
I'm all right.
Just all right?
Yeah.
You got a cowboy hangover?
No. We've got, there's a lot going on. There's a lot of news, and it's not all positive news.
You seem very anxious. A lot of anxiety.
You know what I need? I need to, I got to update my list. My list of pirates that were on the football team in 2022 that will not be on the team in 2023. Because we have another name, and a pretty big name, that is entering the transfer portal, and that is East Carolina cornerback Malik Fleming.
Is that what hurt you?
I mean, I wouldn't say hurt, but it doesn't help.
Nah, because he has 1 year of eligibility left. Do you think he might maybe be following his coach that just left?
I mean, we could just ask the coach.
Yeah. Do you want to do that?
Well, what I do know is that he's a shark. He's a shark, and he's always moving forward. He's never moving backwards. Now, I did tell him, I said, I'm going to Louisville. You can be a Cardinal. Because you can never see a Cardinal and a Blue Jay in the same birdcage. But he is a shark. So he can go over wherever he wants. He smells
Jaquan
blood.
McMillan. Jaquan McMillan.
Malik Fleming.
Malik Fleming entering the transfer portal. So another pirate gone. And again, the list continues. We had at the end of the week, what was it, Friday, Taji Hudson, Rick DeBrew, and Manny Hickman,
yes,
entering the portal. So the portal continues to fill up with pirates and players across the country.
Yeah. Are you going to go to Media Day next year and just ask, say, look, in December or January, are you going to be in the portal, or are you going to be here in the spring?
Should we start asking players just straight up? Is that what you're saying?
Just say, do you take this scholarship? Till death do you part.
To be your awfully wedded scholarship?
Yes. Don't leave me. Don't leave me. I don't care if your coaches leave or what. Just don't leave me.
I mean, at this point, I just plan on everybody leaving. And if they stay, it's like a bonus.
Yeah. It's like, hey, look, Mason Garcia's still here. Let's talk about who's here.
All right. We do have some folks that are sticking around.
I will say this. The news from ECU and the portal lately has been more exiting than entering.
Yeah.
There was a few days where we had two or three players coming in.
Yeah.
So that was, you know, which is always interesting, but it's just the nature of the beast right now.
Some Chapel Hill DBs coming in. But the thing that hurts about this one is not only because Malik Fleming is such a, you know, huge part of this defense, especially in the secondary, but, you know, when, especially on Friday, I got to that point where, okay, this might be it. Like, we might be in the clear for the rest of the offseason. And then, boom. It's Tuesday, and then you find out you're losing your top cornerback that was supposed to be coming back. So when do you get kind of comfortable? I guess you have to look back.
You don't, because, I mean, even after spring ball, when you start to see where you are on that depth chart, and this guy might have outplayed me, and so I'm going to go somewhere else.
There's probably a dead period, like you said. There's a dead period between now and then spring ball. And if spring ball comes around, and just like you just said,
I would think the dead period is going to come when every university is back in session, because these kids have to be in school somewhere. I mean, like, maybe Malik Fleming is transferring to somewhere that has not started classes back yet, which could be possible. in certain areas, because in the north, or maybe they, I don't know when, but they have to enroll, and then they probably want to do spring ball. The other thing after spring ball too is, where do you fall in the depth chart? And then what happens if such and such university has injuries, and then they're like, ooh, let's go in the portal and find a shovel ready, you know, cornerback or running back or wide receiver, because Clip is not going to be ready by the time he's going to miss the first month of September, you know, of football season. So it's never going to end. It's always, I do think there's got to be some sort of stop when school starts, because everybody has to be at school.
Alex says we get comfortable when the plane takes off to Ann Arbor. That's when we know who's on the team.
And that is true. Even in the midst of fall camp, we don't know what's going to happen.
A quick look at the numbers on Hoist the Colors, according to the 24/7, and, you know, keeping up with who's in the portal and who East Carolina gets out of the portal. I have that number. The scoreboard right now, the Buccaneer Music Hall scoreboard, is 13-8. 13 Pirates entering, 8 coming out from other schools to East Carolina.
So we got a -5.
We're at a -5 point differential at the moment.
So when do we expect that number to get back to even, or what are you forecasting? You know how the guy that comes on the NBC Sunday night and does all the forecasting of the playoff? When, you know, 20% here, blah, blah, blah. And then maybe that's what
I'm expecting our incoming number to go up.
Okay.
As far as if it evens out,
I mean, just,
no clue.
Just like, you know, people leaving the program here at ECU don't get comfortable with us being comfortable with what we have now. Like, I'm sure these coaches are continuing to get some people in. So, like you said, the incoming numbers probably could get to even with 13.
You got
to
be comfortable to being uncomfortable, Ellery.
Yeah, I think what would make you more comfortable is if everybody had name tags at media day for spring ball. Just be easier, because a lot of new faces for you.
A lot of new faces. And still, you know, some guys returning as well. It was great to catch up with one of the outgoing Pirates yesterday, as Alex says on Facebook. He enjoyed the chat with Noah Henderson. What an interesting guy he is. Born in Iceland, Ellerby. One of the first Icelandic people I've ever met.
I've missed some of it. Did you ask him what you call if you're from Iceland?
I did not.
An Icelander?
I don't know. But he is hopefully going to be playing at the next level. Had a good showing down at the Hula Bowl, as did Holt Naylor. Speaking of Holt Naylor, some other news. He'll be playing in another All-Star game.
Yeah, the NFLPA Bowl on January the 28th.
So does that officially make him part of the NFL Players Association?
Makes him part of that bowl game on January the 28th at the Rose Bowl.
Maybe he thinks if you go to that, you're automatically in the NFL.
Or maybe you just stay out there and sign with the Rams or Chargers.
Yeah, just never come back.
Yeah, absolutely. Maybe, you mentioned how many other people are really hitting Iceland right now for football players. You know, maybe during these portal crisis times.
We got to expand the horizons.
Can sharks go up to Iceland?
They can't survive there.
I thought sharks could survive anywhere.
No, not in Iceland. Not in Iceland.
Okay.
No. I got to go. I got to go to Louisville. I can't stick around here much longer.
Linville,
I'm a shark.
Linville Joseph came from the Caribbean, like the Bahamas, or where was Linville from? He was somewhere down in a Caribbean island first before he...
Well, they like that warm water.
I know. So, he wasn't a defensive back, but he was, you know.
Well, fake coach Steve Ellis, what he doesn't know is some sharks, some species of sharks like cold water. They have adapted to life in polar regions in the deep sea, where temperatures can reach anywhere between 0.7 degrees Celsius to 4 degrees Celsius, frighteningly cold. So there you go, Coach.
By the way, LRB, Linville Joseph came from the Virgin Islands.
Virgin Islands. There we go. I knew he was somewhere really cool.
Chandler lived there for a long time, his life. Some say he still is. Redbeard says you can transfer at halftime, so you can never be comfortable. I don't know if that is a reference to a Pirate walking out of...
Leaving the bowl game.
Leaving the Birmingham Bowl.
Doing the Antonio Brown. Just calling it a career at the half.
You know what? Good half, boys. I'm out.
At the half, the Pirates up 8 and down a defensive back. We'll be back right after this.
College football athletics in 2023. That is the way it is.
I think it's cool. And back to Holt Naylor's, though, I think it's really cool. He got another opportunity to showcase his talents after having such a great Hula Bowl. Maybe it just increases his exposure, more players, more scouts for him to get in front of.
He's going to have that surgery one of these days.
I was going to say, yeah, where is he at with that now?
Because he was supposed to have that right after the Hula Bowl and start recovering and getting ready for pro day and stuff like that. And now he's got to wait till at least the end of the month.
Maybe he should, just while he's in Los Angeles, just ask if there is an actual Hula Bowl in Hawaii, since he's going to be a lot closer. You know, played the Hula Bowl in Orlando, the NFLPA Bowl in Los Angeles. So.
We need to get that thing out of Orlando and back in Hawaii. So our guys, Warren Saba and Noah Henderson and Holt Naylor, can enjoy a trip to Hawaii.
Absolutely.
Instead of going down to Florida.
100%.
So that is January 28th. It'll be on the NFL Network, the NFLPA Bowl. So I guess that does push back any surgery Holt Naylor was planning on having this postseason. And there's a window. I know he wants to be able to do some things at Pro Day here at ECU.
Sure.
Which is like, what, April, March?
I don't know.
Yeah, so got to get that done as well. All right, there are some other news and notes. New football coach. We have a guy named Jules on the staff. It's a cool name.
Yes.
Jules Montanare. He was at Temple as a cornerbacks coach. He will be taking over for Steve Ellis. So, Chandler, you'll have to talk to him at Media Day. Maybe he has a distinctive voice and you could do a Jules impression.
Yeah, maybe he uses another animal as a like a motivation. Like I'm, Steve Ellis.
We are giraffes.
I'm giraffe. I'm thinking fake Steve Ellis should interview his replacement.
How you gonna replace me?
How you gonna replace me?
I
had Malik Fleming. I had Jaquan McMillan. Who are you gonna
McMillan?
Have? Don't see a dorsal fin on you.
But how about the Pirates going within the conference for the next two openings at assistant coach, with Coach Mo coming from South Florida, and then Coach,
you're really sticking with that name, huh?
Coach Mo.
you know people like are getting into car wrecks right now. When you
come, so, Coach Mo's back.
You're just saying it so casually.
I know. You really dropped it like we all call him that, and that's how he's known.
Like, Al Mogridge.
Like we've
Mogridge.
This, like we've had this person on the air. You know, it's like all of a sudden. No. Well,
got him from South Florida, and then we got this guy from Temple.
The new offensive line coach, who you call Coach Mo.
And I will continue to call Coach Mo.
What if he says, don't call me Coach Mo?
Well, then I won't call him Coach Mo.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. I will respect his wishes.
So two bad teams below ECU in the standings. We are at coaches from there. Not that means anything.
I mean, I'm just stating the facts.
Yeah. We're fact tellers here.
Yeah.
And that's all we are. And as far as coach openings go, as of right now, we are full, correct? As far as we know?
Yes.
Yes.
Two out, two in?
Yeah.
Which one out was
special teams
coach
coordinator
Shane.
Still there.
So we're back to even in the transfer portal for coaches.
Ellerby, I've got that at 2-2 on the Buccaneer Music Hall scoreboard.
So we're just down five by players.
Five players, even on coaches.
I like it.
All right.
I like it.
Other football news today. We have a new football series, a two-game series. It'll be with the Liberty Flames. Mm. Liberty, 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 Liberty. 2024 will be the first game in that series. 2029 will be the return date. So it'll be, let's see, East Carolina and Liberty in 2024. And that game will be in Lynchburg, Virginia.
Correct.
In 2024, at home in 2029. I guess East Carolina had a BYU game scheduled in 2024.
I think what happened is East Carolina had three home games again in 2024, and I think they rescheduled the BYU game so they would not have that same scenario where you have, I mean, which would have been seven home games, but it's, as we saw, if they schedule them all in September, it makes it kind of a little brutal for the fans. But so I think they moved that one to 2025. You got it pulled up right here. Is that correct?
And yeah. So 2024 now has Norfolk State, Appalachian State at home, at Old Dominion, at Liberty, as far as the non-conference schedule. 2025 right now has BYU at home and road contest against Marshall and NC State.
So we got an opening in 2025.
Correct.
And 2024, I mean,
which looks like it'll probably be an FCS opponent.
2024, two very travelable road games to just go up to, you know, Norfolk to Old Dominion and Lynchburg to Liberty. I've heard, I mean, Liberty's facilities I've heard are incredible. So,
and they got a good program.
Yeah, I mean, Hugh Freeze just left there and went to Auburn, and the Coastal coach just went there.
Yeah, Chadwell, who apparently him and Houston have a rivalry from back of their previous
teams. Oh, really?
So that'll be good. We can ask Mike Houston about that, and he won't tell us anything.
How about those freaking Pirates?
We're going to beat those freaking Flames.
Those freaking Pirates?
We're having a freaking game.
And Liberty's getting ready to join a conference here, too? Because they've been
they're
independent.
They're in the...
They've been an independent. But what they're getting ready, are they going Sun Belt?
Is it Fun Belt or CUSA or where are they?
I think it's Fun Belt.
Liberty, they're in Conference USA currently.
They were in Conference USA this year? They weren't independent?
I believe so. It might have been their first year.
I thought they were in a transitional
period. They're moving
period.
To Conference USA this year.
Okay.
There you go. All right, so what do you think about Liberty, Ellery, on the football field?
Like a scheduling.
You like the idea of a short trip, it seemed like.
I mean, we're already playing Old Dominion. If you're playing Old Dominion, why not play Liberty?
Well, if you're already playing one, why play the other? You've already got the local Virginia.
So your offer really, I mean, obviously choice 1 through 4 to me would be State, Carolina, Duke, and Wake.
Mm-hmm.
To play those four in a home and home series. And then after that, then I think you have to go to, like, Old Dominion and Liberty.
Well, Virginia Tech.
Sure.
Obviously, we would like a bigger name opponent.
Right.
Kind of, okay, taking that out of it. Then you start to go, I guess, regional, right?
I think the bigger question, if you're an ECU fan, is do you like one and dones and get a paycheck and play, like, at Michigan, at Florida,
yeah,
at Texas, or let's just say that is an example. Or would you rather have a home game against Norfolk State or, you know, Gardner-Webb? You know, is that what is your strategy of scheduling? Do you prefer the Pirates moving forward, going with if you're getting a one and done, do you want a home game with the FCS, or would you rather it be a road game and a paycheck with a national recognized program?
Yeah, and with that schedule that I mentioned in 2024, not the most attractive non-conference schedule we've ever seen, certainly. If you've already got Norfolk State, Old Dominion, App State, would you like to then go for an at Florida in that case? Or do you add a Liberty? I mean, there's a chance. Now, in 2024, everybody's going to be excited about the new college football playoff, right? So it's like,
if you win all four of those games,
right,
you win 8 of your conference, or go 6-2 in the conference,
you got a shot,
and win the conference championship game. I mean, are you better off moving forward not playing as what's appeared to be tough non-conference games to get a better record, get a higher ranking? And obviously winning conference games is going to be your ticket, and winning the conference championship game is going to be your ticket. But it doesn't really help if you go 8-0 in the conference and go 0-4 non-conference, because you're never going to crack the top 25.
Yeah.
And then, so, I mean, it's just a lot of moving parts. And I still think East Carolina still, I mean, we've had great back-to-back winning seasons, but I mean, let's prove that East Carolina can go 4-0 against those opponents coming up in 2024. You know, I don't know. I mean, with 100% confidence, do you feel great about, like, I mean,
especially with all the roster turnover?
I mean, I just still don't feel like we sit here and been like, well, we got to turn our nose down at, you know, or up at these schools. I mean, with the exception of maybe the FCS school, you feel confident at this point that we're beyond losing to FCS teams.
I mean, last time we played App State, it didn't go well.
Correct.
Yeah. Old Dominion took care of them, played them close last time we went there. So we should be able to knock off Old Dominion, but again, we don't know who's going to be on the field in 2024. Next we don't year, know who's going to be on the field next year.
Take out Gardner-Webb, but next year's three other non-conference games at Michigan, at Appalachian, and Marshall at home. I mean, those are that's a tough schedule.
Yeah,
I mean, Marshall's coming off a year where they won a bowl game, they beat Notre Dame in South Bend. I mean, don't have to tell you about Michigan's resume, and then of course, you just said App, and we're going to Boone. Look, let's proof's going to be in the pudding.
Justin adds, I guess in that 2024 year, he says at Charlotte in conference. So three drivable road games. Be the first time that's been the case,
man,
in a long time.
We might need to buy an RV, Clark.
Looking at what Tulane did, because if the expanded format was in play this year, Tulane would have been there in the playoff, right? So they went 12-2 overall, but in the regular season, they beat UMass, who is one of the worst teams in FBS. They beat FCS school Alcorn State. Their big non-conference win was at Kansas State, but also they lost a non-conference game to Southern Miss. So they got a really good, high-quality non-conference win, and then a not-so-great non-conference loss. Then, of course, they go into conference play, beat Houston, ECU, South Florida, Memphis, and Tulsa. SMU, Cincinnati was the big one. But they had one conference loss at home to UCF. So if you're kind of looking for a blueprint on how to possibly get there, you're going to have to obviously do well in conference play, but take care of business in your non-conference as well. They didn't fully do that with a loss to Southern Miss, but were able to beat some really quality teams. Now, we're not going to have the quality of opponents in conference play that Tulane had. But you would think if you go 10-2, is that enough, Ellerby?
Well, the other thing I think you have to figure out, like getting by and being in the conversation would be 3-1 non-conference and 6-2 in the conference, which would make you 9-3. Now, if you do that, I think that's like the floor of where like you possibly can be. The problem is if you do that, or even if you're 10-2, and then you got an 11-1 or 12-0 Boise team out west sitting there. Then
one of those Sun Belts.
Yeah, because there's no guarantee all conference teams get into this college football playoffs. That's still probably the best of the group of five. I mean,
it's only going to be one.
One from the group of five.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you're going to have to, be in the conference championship game and win the conference championship. So you're going to have to go 7-1, 8-0 or 6-2, maybe, depending. But then the wild card is if Boise or someone else ever catches fire out west again. The other conferences, the MAC and the Mountain West and Conference USA in Sun Belt, they haven't, if App goes 12-0, then they put some heat and they knock off a big boy in a non-conference game or something. That's just where the variance does. But, maybe two get in a scenario like that. If two non, Power Five schools are 11-1 or right there together in two different.
I don't think so.
You don't think?
No.
So let's run a scenario that an American school goes 12-1, wins the American, and then a MAC school or a Mountain West school has like the year of their life and is undefeated. And they have like a MAC school is knocked off like Purdue or Indiana. Like they have, some quality in beating a Power Five team, or in Boise State, they knock off some. You don't think that two, and it all depends on what the other 10 do, because really, you got to realize the SEC is going to have what, six of the other slots.
Right, exactly. And you would have like if there's an upset in one of the championship games or something. Like this year, who beat TCU in the championship?
Kansas State.
So, like, you go ahead and slide them in, probably. So, like, we start doing what we do on NCAA selection show tournament day, where you start saying, all right, these are your at-larges right now. These teams are going to win their tournaments. And then when those teams get upset, those top teams, and you have to add another spot, like, that's kind of, you start, I don't know, teams start jockeying for position. But like this year, looking at the rankings, because you had, I think, a couple teams. The UTSA finished in the top 25, I believe they did, who, by the way, they'll be joining our conference.
Correct.
But looking at, I think, Troy maybe as well. Fresno State finished in the top 25. Troy was number 19. Tulane was all the way up to number 9, but like 12-2 Troy isn't going to sniff it, because you've got
no. I think an American school can have one. It just comes down if an American school is 12-1 and you have an undefeated school somewhere else. Not named Boise, because I think an undefeated, you know, it just depends on what Boise plays at.
Is the new American that attractive to where it's like head and shoulders above the others?
I think the new American is still the best group of five conference.
Yeah.
Prove me wrong.
All right. I can't right now. Relax.
No. Prove it.
Chill out. We had Mike on Facebook talking about who do you schedule, regional opponent, or do you go, you can go FCS, or do you get that payday, go on the road against the big boy? He said, if the athletic department is still in a hole financially, then road game plus paycheck makes the most sense until they aren't.
I hate to say it like this, but I don't understand the finances of college athletics, because 3 years ago, during COVID, everybody was broke. People were taking pay cuts. I thought people were going to close the doors. People were not taking bonuses, yada, yada, yada.
We need to cut sports.
Two years later, drunken spending, you know. I mean, it's like waking up with the worst hangover of your life, swearing off you're not going to drink again, and then you're at the bar at 5 o'clock. I mean, it does not make any sense. And so I don't, like, I hear what he's saying, like, go get a paycheck. At this point, are they going to, until they shut the doors on some university and some athletic department, I just think they all have enough money just to do whatever.
Yeah, it's so, all monopoly money.
It doesn't seem real. It seems like everyone's, you know, playing in crypto or something. I don't know what's really going on. I guess paychecks are being cashed around the country, but I mean, it's just really amazing to me that you know, and now every college athletic department or university, they need more money, and they need it privately for NIL. So, I mean, there's more people with their hand out, and they need to stack, you know, cash money in their hands. So
yeah.
It's
Ellerbe, during the COVID years, and we're talking about what sport's going to look like on the other side of this, and you're like, hey, maybe we finally have some common sense come out of this and play more regional and everything. You know, you don't – but no, you're right. It just went right back to the way it was. It went, like, further than it was before. As far as spending and money and
Jim Harbaugh took, I mean, I'd like to see how much of a pay cut he took a few years ago. And now he has dabbled his name out enough about NFL circles, and Michigan is going to go get a Brinks truck and back it up to his house and dump a lot of cash and money and pay him more than he ever took in a cut. I mean, it's like nothing lost. We're all good. Yeah. We're whole again.
All right, we've got more news to get to. We'll get to that on the other side regarding ECU basketball. Ellerbe, you conducted an interview earlier today, and we got a big and I hate doing this. I'll be honest, I don't like doing this.
You don't like being a tease?
No. Well, I have to tell you folks that we have a big announcement coming up Thursday, but I can't say anything about it.
Thursday at 3 o'clock, we're going to have a big announcement right here in this studio.
But, like, that's it? We can't say anything else?
That's our announcement right now. I think people will be very interested to stick with us between now and Thursday at 3 o'clock.
Well, sure. Just be here Thursday at 3, but...
Yeah, but stay the rest of today and tomorrow, because Clip Brock's got a lot of great stuff planned. But Thursday, we're gonna make an announcement.
We have an announcement Thursday.
And invite a guest on the program. And
it's regarding a guest.
And I think it's going to be very interesting, and I think it's going to be something that a lot of people are going to like and love.
First time this person has ever been on Pirate Radio?
Yes.
Okay. See, now if we can start giving a little bit of tidbits.
We'll do more. But
maybe we need Sports Detective in here to drop some hints.
In the meantime, just go with that and keep fake Steve Sharks away from me, and I won't have to be bitten and tell anymore.
All right. Well, stay in cold water. Apparently, sharks don't go in cold water.
Yep.
All right. We got some thanks for hanging out, Ellerbe.
Yeah, appreciate it.
Enjoyed the chat, as always. Take a break, come back, hear from Mike Schwartz. Bad news regarding ECU basketball. And Javon Small, they're going to be out with his services for a while. We'll find out how long and more when we return after this.
Hey, Hey, Pirate fans, did you know there are thousands of special needs children and adults right here in our community that loves ECU Athletics as much as you do? Robbie's Clubhouse is a local nonprofit organization that can turn your unused ECU tickets into a fun day for a family with special needs. If you can't make it to the next Pirate game, simply call 1-800-DIAL-ECU and donate and designate your tickets for Robbie's Clubhouse. Go Pirates!
To keep your bodies active and engaged in the activities that you love, you need a good stretch. And at Bodies in Balance, that's the mission they follow to give you the best quality of life. With years of experience, the team at Bodies in Balance can create a stretch or massage program that's right for you. Visit them at 3101 South Evans Street in Greenville or schedule a home visit to receive a stretch or massage in the comfort of your own home. Call today at 916-4530 to schedule your first stretch consultation or massage appointment and check them out online at bodiesandbalance.com.
When it comes to hauling dirt, asphalt, or stone, you can trust the pros at First and Goal Hauling Incorporated. They have a fleet of dump trucks ready to get the job done. And best of all, it's owned and operated by ECU football alum Dakota Marshall. When you have a big job and you need it done right, count on First and Goal Hauling, where it's a touchdown every time. Keep up with Dakota Marshall and First and Goal Hauling by following them on Facebook today.
America's favorite light beer, Bud Light, is also the official beer of the ECU Pirates. When planning your fun times with family and friends, be sure to pick up some Bud Light at your favorite retailer. Bud Light carefully brews their beer to be perfect for anywhere there's fun, because when there's fun, Bud Light is there. Always have fun, Pirate Nation, and always stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Go Pirates!
This is Holton Ehlers. I've been eating at Parker's Barbecue since I was a kid. Now, all these years later, I still love to eat at Parker's. In fact, I love it so much, I bring my entire offensive line with me. They protect me, and I look out for them with great food from Parker's Barbecue. So whether you bring the team like me, or just your friends and family, the awesome barbecue, chicken, and seafood at Parker's is a win every time. Parker's Barbecue, where they always treat you like family.
Add some sparkle and style to your home and save at Bostick Sugg Furniture. Give your home a new look in the new year with beautiful new furniture. Right now, get a Bostick Sugg first time ever offer with three ways to save. One, get a sales tax discount on any purchase. Two, get a $100 in MasterCard rewards cards for every $1,000 you spend. And finally, get 6 months special financing. So add some sparkle and style to your home with a little help from Bostick Sugg Furniture.
Great. It's 30 degrees in here. This is going to be a cold night.
No one's coming out this late.
I'm on firewood.
Dad! I'll put hot coals in our socks for bedtime.
Mom!
Hi, I'm from Delcor Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing. Got an email about your heat being out?
That was me. I sent it from my phone.
I think your socks are on fire.
Ah! Call Delcor today to get a new system installed for less than $100 a month. Offer expires soon. Go to DelcorInc.com. Monthly fee based on new system financing is 9.9% APR for 120 months. Call Delcor for details.
Hey, Pirate Nation, Lindsey Gray here with Carolina Caliber. In 1960, my granddaddy started his firearm business right here in Eastern NC. Still family-owned and operated, we have the area's largest selection for outdoor shooting sports and accessories and are one of the nation's top firearm dealers. At Carolina Caliber, we have everything you need from hunting, home defense, and personal protection, including a wide variety for ladies and youth. We buy, sell, and trade. It's a time-honored tradition. Visit us at Carolina Caliber on Fire Tower Road in Winterville.
This is Coach Blake Harrell, defense coordinator for East Carolina football, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour One of Pirate Radio Live. This hour is brought to you by University PC Care, your local tech support experts for all your personal and business needs. Visit universitypccare.com to learn more today. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Brown & Wood is your home of the best selection of GMC, Cadillac, Buick, and Mazda in Eastern North Carolina since 1937. Shop their entire inventory online at brownandwoodauto.com or visit them on Greenville Boulevard. Brown & Wood, Greenville's number one dealership and the home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Cliff.
East Carolina Liberty have a football series. Home and home, beginning 2024 at Liberty, 2029 at East Carolina. I mentioned that Chadwell, the new coach there in at Liberty, Jamie Chadwell from Coastal Carolina, and Mike Houston had some sort of a rivalry, and I guess Steven Igo was tuned in and sent me a link as to some of that. The Citadel and Charleston Southern rivalry turned sour. Charleston Southern was coached by Jamie Chadwell, the Citadel, Mike Houston. Jamie Chadwell, I guess, inherited a bad Charleston Southern program, took over and started winning, and included three straight wins over the Citadel, and in 2015 broke out a broom on the sidelines, I guess after the game, or, you know, in the middle of the field. He's holding a broom for a, what he called a, I guess, a sweep. It was sweeping at midfield. The players were yelling, sweep, sweep, sweep. And apparently, Coach Houston, he said, so then they split conferences, and Chadwell said after a victory that there's probably not a chance that we're ever going to play them again as long as I'm here, and maybe while Coach Mike Houston is here. But they, I guess, will meet on the field in 2024. That'll be good. So Chadwell and Houston apparently don't like each other. I don't know if we can get Mike Houston to talk about this, but we'll certainly try when they meet on the field in 2024. Thank you, Igo, for that Sports Illustrated article. All right, we mentioned other football news. There is some basketball news. Javon Small did not play in the game against South Florida on Sunday. He was sorely missed in the Pirates' loss, and he will not play against Temple on Wednesday night, and that is a huge blow to a now struggling East Carolina basketball team who has lost four games in a row. Mike Schwartz talked about that and more earlier today. Chan Man was out there. Let's hear some of that right now.
Good day of practice yesterday in preparation as we move towards Temple after the loss versus South Florida, and looking forward to a good practice today, getting prepared to head to Philadelphia afterwards this afternoon.
Coach, I know, kind of said Javon will be out a while. Can you just update us on his status?
Yeah, he will not be available tomorrow at Temple, and we're still kind of trying to gather to get a timeline of exactly when, you know, when he'll be healthy again.
Just how, you know, difficult is that for you guys, one of your key players, and to learn to play without him going forward?
Yeah, sure. Of course, it's difficult. You know, he leads us in scoring, leads us in assists. He's a high usage guy for us. The ball's in his hands, late clock, you know, what we do on offense. And he's a really good rebounder. I mean, still, he's a guy who's between 4 and 5 rebounds. He's one of the top 20 rebounders in this conference. And as a point guard, that's a lot. But probably what's even more challenging this, you don't just replace those statistics. Obviously, it doesn't work like that. But it changes the rotation, and it changes how you have to try and play. And that's probably the bigger challenge.
You guys didn't see Damian last time, but he had a big game against Memphis. What do you see as far as the former Kinston star?
Yeah, he's just a phenomenal scorer. I mean, he's a he's a very talented player. He's one of the very best guards and scoring offensive players that there is in this league, and just makes Temple even that much better than they were when they were here, and they were really good when they were here too.
You kind of touched on the defense the other day. With Javon being out, is it even more important to, like, really get into that and play defense, keep you guys in games?
Yeah, of course. You know, I think it, regardless of if you have everyone healthy or you don't, I mean, you know how I feel about defense and what I think and where we have to have it. And we had a really nice 5-game stretch. Defense didn't mean that we were able to win all those games, but we were playing really good on the defensive side from a statistical standpoint and also doing what we wanted. And then versus Cincinnati in particular, and versus South Florida, our ability to defend the three-point line was not very good. And it started from the beginning of the game, the Cincinnati game, and we know what they did. And then South Florida, mostly in the second half, you know, Tyler Harris got going, and we didn't defend the three-point line those two games. You know, you go back to that Memphis game, we lose, but it really wasn't our defense. It was our offense that allowed them to have high offensive numbers because we turned it over so much, and it led directly to baskets. And there's no defense for that. Anytime they're turning you over in a trap or a turnover that leads to a layup, the numbers are going to be high. And that was the Memphis game. So I really didn't look at that as a poor defensive game. In fact, we played really well defensively in the first half and even the second half. We just couldn't. Ball security really hurt us. But we have not been very strong on defense on the road at Cincinnati and the other day versus South Florida.
This is the first team you've seen twice in the season. Do you go back and look at the film of the first game and harp on that a lot, or do you just have to use this game kind of as an individual game?
No, yeah, a little bit of both. I mean, you absolutely have to go back, and, I mean, we studied that game film a ton, and you look at it. But, again, as Brian alluded to, that, you know, Damian Dunn will be available this game, so they were without him. But you go back definitely and you look at what they did that hurt us. You look at anything that we were able to have success with, and you hope we can capitalize on that. And you look at that, but then they're playing really good basketball. Remember, when they came in to play us, it was right after the break. They had not been playing their best basketball leading into the break. And Coach McKee did a great job. He shifted the lineup around, and they really found something. They're playing as good as anybody is in this league right now. So going into our game, what they did in here and what they've done since, and obviously they're coming off of a very difficult loss the other day versus Memphis, they're playing as good a basketball as anyone, and they've got Dunn back. So you have to also look at what they've been doing presently and more recently.
Last year, when these teams met in Temple, Damian Dunn hit a dagger three at the buzzer to beat the Pirates. The Kinston product will be on the court facing East Carolina tomorrow night. He was not available in the first meeting between these two teams. I said going into AAC play that despite a not-so-great non-conference for Tulane, I think they were 7-4, going into conference play, I said, you know, Ron Hunter's guys are going to turn it on when league play begins. Sure enough, they're 5-1, half game back of Houston for the conference lead. I did not say the same thing about Temple. Temple was 6-7 going into conference play. They have turned it on when league play began. Good grief, if we hit some free throws, we beat Temple. And our record looks a little bit different a few weeks ago, but Temple comes in here, wins that game. They're 4-2 in conference play, as Mike Schwartz just said. You heard him say they're playing just about as good as anybody in the league right now. So they have played well in a conference so far. Looking at the standings, Houston a perfect 5-0. Chandler, will Houston lose an American game this season?
I don't. They've come close a few times. I think South Florida put up a good fight against them. They've been in some ball games, but they're a really talented team. I want to say they lose at least one.
Well, if they lose
there's going to be an upset somewhere with Houston.
If they lose one, it could be tonight. They are on the road at Tulane. They have Temple at home, then they are on the road at UCF, which would be the other kind of obvious loss. So I think they do lose one. I think it's going to be one of the next three, and could very well be tonight.
Of course, Corey Glover has a chance to call two upsets in the same month with Tulane football knocking off Caleb Williams and the USC Trojans, and then tonight potentially against the Houston Cougars.
Tulane 5-1 in conference play. Houston 5-0. Temple and UCF, along with Cincinnati, are 4-2. Memphis is 3-2. Wichita State 2-3. Pirates knocked off the Shockers, and we'll see them again soon. South Florida, SMU, ECU, all sitting at one win, and then Tulsa down there at the bottom, still looking for their conference first conference win. Looking at what's going on this week in the AAC, of course, Pirates will be in action Wednesday against Temple. Tonight, it is Houston at Tulane. That's a ESPN Plus game. I wish that game could be on regular TV, but it will be a Plus. Cincinnati at South Florida will be Wednesday night, as will SMU and Tulsa, along with East Carolina and Temple. So that's what's going on this week in the American. Is there a Thursday game? There is. Wichita State at Memphis. Tonight in top 25 action, Kansas at Kansas State, Tennessee at Mississippi State. Clemson trying to get to 8-0 in ACC play.
Wow.
When they take on Wake Forest coming up tonight at 9:00 at Lawrence Joel. So there's some games going on tonight. Also, Texas at Iowa State. That is a number 7 versus number 12 matchup. Let's take a break. We'll come back. We'll get ready to wrap up our number 1. The Mully Man going to join us. We actually got some golf news that we'll discuss with Mully. Some ECU baseball news and notes as well that we'll hit on in hour number 2. More to go in hour number 1 when we return on Pirate Radio Live here on a Tuesday. We're back with you after this.
I'm Annalie Newhoff.
And I'm Rob Campbell.
And we are with CopyPro. We have been locally owned and operated here in Eastern North Carolina for almost 50 years. CopyPro is the leader in office technology.
Does your business struggle with keeping printing costs low or producing professional documents? Here at CopyPro, total customer satisfaction is our number one priority.
We have a variety of solutions to help reduce your printing expenses and make your business more productive. Call us today at 1-800-682-6558 or online at copypro.net.
CopyPro. We are the professional office systems people.
Your vehicle is a big part of your life. That's why you should trust the team at Greenville Auto World for all your vehicle needs. Greenville Auto World believes in fair prices, superior service, and treating customers right. Visit GreenvilleAutoWorld.net to see their fully stocked inventory of SUVs, trucks, and cars. Need a lift kit, custom rims, or wheels? Greenville Auto World can upgrade your vehicle today. For sales or service, visit Greenville Auto World on Highway 43 in Greenville.
Hey Pirate Nation, this is Holton Ehlers for my friends at ArcPoint Labs. Just as I trust my teammates, you can trust ArcPoint Labs to give you quick and accurate results for your laboratory testing needs. ArcPoint Labs provides insights and solutions to enable individuals, businesses, and communities to make informed decisions on their health, safety, and well-being. Visit any of the 6 Eastern North Carolina ArcPoint Labs locations or go to arcpointlabs.com. Go Pirates!
You know, texting while driving is dangerous. That's not new information. Yet most people admit to doing it anyway. Drivers are 23 times more likely to be involved in a car accident while texting. Know the facts and wait to text. The danger is real and it applies to you. Auto Owners Insurance. The no problem people. Information provided by Virginia Tech Transportation Institute.
This is Norm Bryant with Town Insurance in Greenville. Call me today at 756-8300. Go Pirates!
Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local. Print it local with University Sportswear. University Sportswear, ENC.com, is your one-stop shop for all promotional products for your business. With over 1 million items to shop from, University Sportswear, ENC.com offers high-quality products at prices to fit any budget. Visit University Sportswear, ENC.com for contact information and to get shopping. University Sportswear, ENC.com, the official sportswear provider of Pirate Radio.
Do you ever talk to yourself about where to eat today, and then you hear
Warren's Hot Dogs?
Then you're thinking, yeah, 2 hot dogs, chips, and a drink for only $6.25 would be awesome.
Warren's Hot Dogs.
And maybe some homemade lemonade, perhaps a pizza or a sub, and definitely an apple or peach turnover.
Warren's Hot Dogs.
Don't overthink where to eat today. Go to Warren's Hot Dogs in Greenville across from Ron Ayers or in Chocowinity next to the fire station. Warren's Hot Dogs, serving the Pirate Nation since 1991. Go Pirates. Pirates.
This isn't your regular cola, so this isn't your regular cola ad. No beach parties or family barbecues here. Just Nitro Pepsi, the first cola ever infused with nitrogen. So forget everything you thought you knew about soda, because that nitrogen gives us a whole new experience. Think an infusion of smaller bubbles for a cola that's got a lighter, smoother texture. And don't get me started on the pour. You don't pour this like any other cola. We're talking turn the can completely upside down and watch as those bubbles cascade into the glass to create a frothy, luxurious foam topping. Can your cola do that? I didn't think so. Unless you've got your own Nitro Pepsi, in which case, cheers to your great taste. Because you already know that the only thing better than the pour is the unapologetic cola taste. What else is there to say? From the creamy foam to the smooth texture to its unbelievably delicious flavor, this is cola like you've never had it before. Time to bring your taste buds to the next frontier. Nitro Pepsi. Smooth, creamy, delicious.
This is Holton Ehlers, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're are listening to Hour 1 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour is brought to you by University PC Care, your local tech support experts for all your personal and business needs. Visit universitypccare.com to learn more today. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Are you in outside sales and looking for an opportunity to increase your earning potential? CopyPro has been in Eastern North Carolina for over 45 years and continues to grow each year. And they are in need of more sales professionals with a desire to potentially make a six-figure income. Do you have what it takes? Visit copypro.net today to submit your resume and to learn more. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Clip.
Back with you, Pirate Radio Live, here on a Tuesday. The early Mully gets the worm. Mike Mullis here, hanging out with us in the Pirate Radio studios. Mully, how you doing on this gray day?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing good. Doing good. We got some baseball, we got some golf, some other things to talk about. We were discussing coming back into the break all the players East Carolina has lost from 2022 to 2023, and that includes graduation and grad transfers and other transfers and going pro and everything in between. And you had a number, I have a number, it's somewhere around 30.
It's a big
at this
number.
Point.
Either way.
Upper 20s, 30, yeah. And I remember going into last season, East Carolina was up there as far as returning production and returning starts and all that stuff. A lot of that had to do with Holton Ehlers, but even CJ Keaton Mitchell, a lot of guys on that defensive side of the ball with Miles, Xavier Smith, guys like that. So it is going to be the complete opposite this year heading into 2023. They are going to be one of the teams with the least amount of experience played, starting, all that, but more importantly, production-wise, because you're losing just about everything from the passing game. You're losing everything. The rushing game, you're losing quite a bit. You've got what Marlon Gunn did and what Rajay was able to do in five games returning. In the receiving game, you got Shane Calhoun, some Jalen Johnson, which that's good, but a chunk of that leaving. You see where I'm going with this.
Yeah,
a lot of production to make up.
Your defensive secondary. It's an awful lot. I would love to know how that ranks, like,
yeah,
nationally.
I was actually looking for most experienced team going into 2022 because I felt like East Carolina was up there very high on that list, and there will be a list that comes out heading into the next season. But we've got to be. I think we go from top 15 to maybe bottom 2015 in the nation.
It's just so hard. Again, it's so hard to call
everybody else. I mean, this is not an ECU thing.
No,
this
it's,
is a
it's not. And this is this does seem like, and maybe it's just because it's in, you know, our backyard, but it does seem like a fairly extreme case.
I agree.
Yeah. Just a lot of and kind of a perfect storm with some of the guys graduating and
yeah,
and obviously guys that are seeking opportunities to play professionally. A couple of which probably are a little bit of a surprise. So, you know, I just don't know if anybody gets old anymore. I don't know that you see that, you know, anywhere.
And get old, stay old is what coaches want to do. And that
yeah,
is,
I mean, try to plug in at least, you know, you want to have these things happen to address needs, right? Like, so you keep your core guys, you protect your culture, you're not having to reteach every year. And honestly, man, what they're seeing is what, you know, all the JUCO coaches out there have dealt with forever, you know, where you're turning rosters over, you know, half your roster every year.
It was designed to be that way,
but
though,
that's
right?
That's right. It's a different deal. And you know, but it's, you know, and with JUCO guys, you're not going out there playing against grown men, you know, that are 22, 23 years old. So, yeah, it's man, it's different. I don't know. You kind of wonder. I guess the portal should close very soon. I think it closed at some point in January, but it's like, hey, can we, you know, go ahead and get that thing closed and, you know, let's move.
So
on.
At least you know what you got for winter workouts.
Yeah,
and preparing for spring ball and all that because it'll open back up and
March, I think,
and we'll see guys leave after spring and yep, things like that. So Mike Mullis joining us inside the Pirate Radio studios. More football talk with Bryce Williams when it comes to East Carolina. We'll talk some NFL playoffs with Mully. We'll talk some ECU baseball with Mully, another ranking for the Pirates. Today we'll discuss that, and I believe we have some live tour TV news to get to as
Oh, really? Did they sign a contract? I have not seen
it. We'll discuss that. So a lot to get to. Hour two of Pirate Radio Live. We'll take a timeout, come back, and have more for you on the other side. Back with you after this.
Buccaneer Music Hall is your beacon of music in the land of pirates. The doors open at noon, 7 days a week. And the Buck has live music every night, along with football. Monday is open mic night, the first Monday of each month. Tuesday, it's karaoke with DJ Captain Morgan. Wednesday, it's acoustic night. Thursday, it's the dance party with DJ Kid Scene, and live music every Friday and Saturday night with the best bands on the East Coast. Follow the Buck on Instagram for information and schedule of events. This season, party like a pirate at the Buck.
Country Mart has been locally owned and operated for over 40 years and is your premier country store serving the best cheese biscuits and country food around. Country Mart is open every day and has two locations in Bethel on Highway 11 and in Stokes on Highway 903. Both Country Mart locations are top-of-the-line fuel stations serving Shell gas, including 93 ethanol-free high-octane gas. Country Mart, fueling you up with great food in your engines with great gasoline. Go Pirates!
Happy New Year. This is Talbot Green, and I'm excited to announce our new partnership with Integrity Home Mortgage. Integrity Home Mortgage offers a wide variety of programs ranging from conventional, government, and portfolio loans, plus construction and lot loans. Our Integrity Home Mortgage team of Talbot Green, Braxton Green, and Joanne Weir offer over 50 years of experience and is committed to providing you with superior customer service.
To get started, call me, Braxton Green, at 526-8260.
NMLS 28516, Equal Housing Lender.
Do you want to get rid of wrinkles, tighten and lift your skin, smooth your skin texture, erase veins and brown spots, get rid of unwanted hair and under-eye fat pads? Are you interested in Botox or filler? Contact the licensed professionals at Beauty Bar Medi Spa for a free consultation and ask about our newest technologies and treatments. Learn more at beautybarmedispa.com. Red Banks Road, Greenville. Enjoy your visit, love your transformation, and go Pirates!
You've worked hard to make your business successful, and that's why it's really important to always have a bank in your corner when you need them. This is former ECU baseball player Ashley Capps from First Bank, and our experienced team of local bankers includes Lee Watson, Bonner Latham, Chris Richards, Josh Hooten, and Heath Nisbet. To get the business services that are right for your business today, come and see someone on our team at First Bank on Arlington Boulevard here in Greenville. First Bank, together with our customers, we're creating a world where individuals and communities thrive.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
What happened to your New Year's resolution?
My resolution is to eat better. Epic Stuff Crust. Better ingredients, better pizza. I'm eating better.
What are you guys doing in my house? Don't answer. I thought you said you wasn't coming back.
Hey, Pirate fans. Papa John's is the MVP move for game day or any day. Place your order online at papajohns.com and sign up for Papa Rewards. Papa John's. Better ingredients, better pizza. Go Pirates.
This is Mark Washington with Max Sports Performance at Max Fitness. Our facility has reopened and is following all safety protocols. The best thing you can do to strengthen your immune system is, of course, to work out and exercise on a regular basis. I can assist you as your performance coach. You can also enjoy the benefits of a private facility. Avoid the crowds and work out at Max Fitness. Now is the time to get healthy. Max Fitness, just off Highway 43 in the old Ace Hardware building behind Speedway in Greenville. Call me, Mark Washington, 902-4877.
It's bow time. You've probably heard folks say, don't call it a comeback. But at Bojangles, we don't like to beat around the bush. So when the sizzling, savory pork chop griller's back in all its tender, marinated chili lime glory, and you can get a pork chop griller combo for just $4.59, go ahead, call it a comeback. Get a legendary pork chop griller combo for just $4.59, only at Bojangles. It's bow time.
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250, and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930, and 104.1 FM Washington. You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by First Bank. Together with our customers, we're creating a world where individuals and communities thrive. Visit the First Bank location on Arlington Boulevard in Greenville for all your personal and business banking needs. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. From sales to service, Greenville Auto World has all of your vehicle needs covered. Shop all of their inventory now at greenvilleautoworld.net. If you're also looking for someone to service your vehicle, Greenville Auto World has a full service and repair facility. They do brakes, oil changes, tires, inspections, and they can repair any kind of vehicle. Greenville Auto World, across from Speedway at Bell's Fork and online at greenvilleautoworld.net. Thanks to Tim Sutton for his sponsorship of the program. Now let's head back into Pirate Radio Live. Here is your host, Clip Brock. Clip!
Mully's leaving, like, throwing out cliffhangers here.
Yeah, it's called a teaser. You might try it.
Can we talk about it on the air?
Negative.
All right. Now I got to do this whole segment thinking about that.
You're welcome.
Speaking of other things we can't talk about on the air, we got a big announcement on Thursday.
I mean, we could talk about it. It's a big announcement.
What do you want to talk about?
It's a big announcement.
Exactly. I hate that stuff.
It's huge. It's monolithic.
Josh, it is not involving the Pirate Radio football kickoff party. I saw you ask about that on Facebook. It is regarding a guest that we're going to have on the show and an announcement on top of that.
There you go.
So,
well done.
Thursday, 3 o'clock. Stay tuned for that. Also, later this week, we will talk to Burley, Alec Burleson, who will be speaking at the upcoming ECU baseball banquet. And got to see him in the bigs and the life of a big leaguer. He's you know what he's doing now, Mully? He's taking classes.
Yeah, that's the deal.
Glamorous. Not so glamorous right now, but hopefully one day for him will be. Right. But awesome to see him with the Cardinals. Speaking of the Cardinals, one of the oddest coach firings in all the sports the last few years, Mike Schilt with the Cardinals, took him to the playoffs pretty much every year and got the axe. But he was on the Brian Bailey show yesterday. Be speaking at the hot stove banquet. So,
do you know there's a tie there?
Give me the tie.
Schilt coached at West Charlotte High School.
Did everybody coach there?
I mean, only the good ones.
Man.
Yeah. After he was after me, but yeah, he's. I mean, you know, not that much older than I am. But
living in Kinston now.
Yep.
And is part of the Padres organization.
I did not know that.
Yeah, so doing something with it. Still in baseball.
Yeah.
Wants to manage again. And
who wouldn't give that guy a chance to manage again? Seems like he did everything right.
Yeah, it was, I guess, one of those disagreements with higher-ups.
A difference in philosophy.
Yeah, philosophy.
And, it, you know, and he's his path to the big leagues was not necessarily normal, you know, and he's he made the most of his opportunity, and you got to think he'll get another chance.
Well, Bailey asked him about it. You know, how unique is it? I'd love to see the numbers on this, Mully. A guy that never played professional baseball, managing professional baseball.
And I don't even think that, I mean, it wasn't that many years ago. He was at West Charlotte High School. I mean, he wasn't even, you know, tolling in the minor leagues or coaching, you know, college baseball. He was at a high school that's not even a premier program in the state.
You made it a premier program in the state when you played, right?
We were okay.
Okay. All right, Mully, where to begin? While we're talking baseball, East Carolina received more recognition in the preseason polls. There is a million of these polls, and this is the first one I'm bringing up because it is D1 baseball. Looked at, I would say, amongst people that follow baseball as the maybe the most legitimate post. I mean, those guys do a really good job.
They do a great
covering
job.
It. But East Carolina, preseason 11th in the D1 baseball poll. This means nothing, but it's good to see your name out there. And for ECU, for the baseball team, they are filling in holes left by some big shoes of Bryson Worrell and Zach Agnos, C.J. Mayhew, guys like that. From last year's team, Ryder Giles no longer at short or on the mound. So Cliff Godwin goes through this every year, has to keep on recruiting studs, but do have some names coming back. Jacob Jenkins Coward, Lane Hoover on the offensive side, AMAC, Moylan, and then on the pitching side, Saylor and Carter Spivey.
Yep.
So, I mean, you'll see a lot of familiar names, a lot of newcomers as well. Well, you've had a chance to see them this offseason. They're about to get cranked back up with practices, scrimmages, things like that. But I don't know. I guess initial thoughts on the 2023.
Look, I mean, I think we talked about it before. I really like the offense behind the plate. Both the guys swung the bat good in the games that I saw in the fall. You know, they've got to obviously fill a hole up the middle. That was a big concern that was left. And, you know, that I'm sure they feel pretty decent about Starling at second. And
and they're good at the other spots. Yeah. It's that shortstop.
Yeah, that shortstop. It's a big one. That's a big one. But, you know, they'll work it out. They'll coach them up. And you know, obviously we've seen that Cliff's not afraid to play situational baseball. And I think you can fully expect that. You may see guys play in that spot late in the game based off of a need for offense or need for defense. And, you know, they'll just manage their way through it.
Mike Mullis joining us. Looking forward to talking more ECU baseball as we get closer to the upcoming 2023 season. Once again, Alec Burleson going to join us later on this week on Pirate Radio Live. Mully, we haven't even mentioned this. The Bucks.
What Bucks?
I mean, that was pitiful.
You know, the other thing I thought you would mention fairly quickly was my calls for last week's games. Remember I said I'll go 90% on this?
Okay, well, I don't remember the games you picked.
All but the Bucks.
So you picked the Bucks?
No, I picked the Bucks. I thought as bad as Dallas looked.
I don't think you picked the Giants, did you?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, NFL guy.
I mean, you know.
Well, let's pick them this week.
All right.
give me the winners.
If you want me to. I like all the home teams. I already looked at it.
What a square.
Well, I mean, it just is what it is.
Who's what road team has the best shot?
Buffalo. But
you mean Cincinnati?
Cincinnati. Josh Allen didn't play great.
Neither did Joe Burrow.
Neither did Joe Burrow.
They both got kind of wake up calls,
right?
And now they play each other,
right? Yeah. So I
like the. I mean, I like the lineup. I hate that Washington wasn't invited to the NFC East Invitational going on this weekend with Giants versus Eagles,
right,
and Cowboys.
The biggest question mark of the whole deal to me is the Eagles, because it just feels fragile. But they have been really good. But, who knows?
And I don't understand this Giants thing. I just don't think they're that good, but clearly they
find a way.
Daniel Jones has made me eat a lot of words and crow and everything in between.
Saquon Barkley was the real deal.
Well, he is. And I thought about this weekend. As a Washington fan, I hate it. As a football fan, I'm glad to see – it's fun to see the best healthy and playing well. And Saquon Barkley, makes the league better
because
he is an elite player.
And the reality is we don't have a ton of elite running backs.
True.
Like, there's a lot of running back by committee kind of deals.
Yeah, and, you're right.
You know, guys that are just okay. Obviously, you know, if you'd like to watch the running game, last night's game was not one to watch on the Tampa side. That was pretty incredible.
No, and I was thinking about that this weekend. So Travis Etienne went over 100 yards. I don't know. Like, McCaffrey receiving and rushing went over 100.
Right.
Barkley receiving and rushing went over 100. But you're right. Like, Joe Mixon with Cincinnati, he throws up a lot of 28-yard games.
Yep.
And then Ezekiel Elliott way past his prime. Tony Pollard is a talented running back. But, there was no running going on last night between any of those teams. Buffalo doesn't really care to run the ball that much. So, you're right. Kansas City's not going to run it that much. Philly does, but they do it by committee, and their most dangerous guy is the quarterback running the ball.
Right.
So it is a new era.
It is a new era. In everything. How many times will I say that? It's just, it's crazy. It's crazy. It's just a different deal. Offense, it's interesting.
Sorry to go national radio here, but is Tom Brady going to retire?
I mean, who knows? I feel like, probably.
But he's going to come out of retirement.
And it's kind of funny. Don't you retire before Giselle leaves you? Like, as opposed to come back for this hot mess that he played in this past year, or go ahead and make a move. Like, if you wanted to go to LA. I do think there was obviously the whole speculation of him going to San Fran, but they're pretty good. That quarterback room is not a problem there. And I mean, San Fran's got three quarterbacks that everybody in the country would, or everybody in the league would like to have. LA. Las Vegas or LA. I don't know. And people kill me. Oh, he's going to go back to New England. He's not going to New England to play in the cold and play for Belichick. It's not going to happen.
Talk about numbers being deceiving. Tom Brady last night, 351 yards, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception.
Right.
That tells none of the story.
No.
He threw the ball 66 times last night.
It was incredible. And there were, I don't know what, 10 of those that were just awful.
Yeah, like fading away, throwing it 5 feet in front of the receiver.
Well, the receiver ran the wrong route. I mean, you know, it was just, I don't know. I'm kind of like, okay, Tom, it's been really cool. And it's kind of winding down for me about, 4 years ago. Now it's like, all right, Tom, hey. But the sad part is, if he comes back, he's still one of the top 15 quarterbacks in the game.
Yeah, that's true.
At 46 years old.
Yeah. Dak with a big bounce back, 305, 4 touchdowns for him, and he got it rolling.
Surely Cowboys fans are not convincing themselves that we're Super Bowl bound. The manic tendencies they have. I don't see him getting by San Fran.
Well, I don't either, but they have the talent to beat anybody,
especially when they play bad teams. Of course, they lost to the Commanders the week before, so
it's smoked. The line is a little more narrow than I was thinking.
Three and a half.
Mm-hmm.
They did suck on it all week.
They had to suck on that all week, according to Jerry Jones, after losing the Commanders. Looking at the lines for this week, Kansas City 8.5 against the Jaguars. You think the Jags can stick around?
No.
Okay. Giants, Eagles, 7.5, Philly.
Eagles.
Minus the points.
Mm.
I think that might be a good one. Buffalo -5. It's a weird number. Against the Bengals. I like the Bengals there.
Do you?
Keep it close. I like a close game.
I think it's going to be a close game.
Keep it tight. We've had some good games other than last night and then the first one. The ones in the middle all going down to the wire there.
Can we talk about just briefly about the comedy that was the extra point debacle last
night? Yeah, we got to.
That was Brett Maher. Ridiculous.
I've never seen anything like that.
That was insane. After the third one, I mean, even Peyton Manning got up on the Manning cast. Did you watch it last night?
I watched the Manning cast.
And he even said on live television, he was like, can you cut a player at halftime? Little did we know that he would do it for a fourth straight time, miss the extra point.
It was hilarious. The Cowboys are celebrating, and by the last one, they're almost like celebrating the win, like great game, and this guy's just out there missing them. And he is like the most depressed man in the world, and everybody else around him is going crazy.
The funny part about all that was every time they scored, obviously they're showing Jerry Jones in his box.
Him
and his son are like hugging and kissing, and then the extra point guy, the kicker, misses the extra point, and then it's like a whole different like look on Jerry Jones. They did it every time.
Well, and it's a real problem. Anytime it's a real problem in the playoffs.
And I believe he's been very solid.
Oh,
all year.
He had 260 yarders against Minnesota, maybe. I mean, would he bring a guy in just, okay, Mar, you're going to kick 60, 50 up, and then this guy's just going to kick the chippies? I don't know. It's hard to run him back out there.
4 straight extra points missed.
That's so 2022, crazy. He was 50 of 53 on extra points, 29 of 32 from field goals. 29 of 32 field goals is a great number in the NFL. So, but now you got that, call it the yips, call it whatever you want.
Well, it's so deep in his head right now.
Yeah, you got to get him to a psychologist today.
Oh,
right?
He's sacrificing a live chicken or something right now. I mean, it's ugly for him.
Pedro Serrano in the clubhouse. That was incredible. The Manning cast was awesome. I tell you what, Dion, I love the Deion chat, and they went long
with
him.
He was coach mode last night.
Yeah, like the X's and O's, they were breaking down, and I didn't understand half of it with my fan brain. But
and he
like,
was asking them questions. Usually it's them asking some of these other guys, especially like coaches.
No, I kind of felt like he was taking advantage of the situation. Like he was in learning, like,
right.
Hey, what do you see here? What do you, yeah, it was,
did you listen to it?
Yeah.
He's awesome.
Has anybody got any more pub than that cat? I mean, he is everywhere.
Yeah. He still does a Barstool NFL show every Sunday.
How does he have time?
He does it remotely, but he does it.
Wow.
And he's out there. And the bad part is Colorado's got to suit it up and play some games.
You know, this is not going to hurt who they put on the sideline.
Nah, yeah. I mean, he's doing his part there. Nick Saban back on TV. We talked about that last week. Yeah. So these coaches are finding themselves out there.
I mean, and public figures, you know.
They also had Dan Campbell. That was not as smooth as the Deion interview.
Yeah, but that's Dan Campbell.
I like Dan.
Like, what did you? What
like, if
you
anybody had spotty internet, you would assume it'd be
Dan
Campbell.
Yeah, what would you expect? he's got this thing held together with duct tape and chewing gum, and you know, he's probably got a Bud Heavy sitting off to the side. I mean, that's just you know.
Yeah.
That's old Dan.
He was
can of dip right beside him.
He was on the roof wiring up the internet before they went on.
Yeah, he's the only person in the world that's got rabbit ears for his internet.
And then they showed they had Teddy Bruschi on later in the game. Did you see the video of his son? Did you see that?
No, I didn't see that. But his mic was so hot when they first got him on. Yeah, it was like blaring through my TV.
So let me see if I can find this because I'm sure it's out there. But he was an assistant coach with his kids' football team. I guess it was high school. They might have been younger. But they got to run through like coaches holding bags one day at practice and kind of hit on the coaches and stuff. So it's Bruschi and two coaches lined up, and then about, you know, 3 feet in front of them, another group of three coaches lined up. The player, I guess, is supposed to run through the middle. Bruschi's kid just goes straight for Teddy and blasts him, puts him on his tail, and everybody goes crazy. And Bruschi was like, and they were like, you got to be a little bit proud of him. He was like, yeah, sure, I was.
Yeah.
But he lit him up. It was awesome. I got to find that video.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Okay.
All right. That's from last night. Did I describe that well?
You did great.
Did I paint the picture?
I mean, even the way you turned, and yeah, it was great.
Let's take a break, Shirley. Can you stick around one more segment?
Sure.
Love
hey,
you.
Hey, the clock's gone.
Yeah, it's been gone.
It's been nice. Gone.
Good.
It's supposed to be getting fixed.
Bryce Williams always brings that up, too.
I'm sure he will today when he comes at 5 o'clock.
Troy's been fixing that since early December.
That is Troy. He would fix that clock as opposed to go spend $19.99 and just get another one.
Nah, he's fixing it, man.
Yeah.
He's got his little tools out.
Yeah.
No, how you doing in there, Troy? He's in there right now getting it done.
Him and Pinocchio. Giuseppe's back there fixing the clock, the master craftsman that he is.
And Troy is a real boy.
He's a high school athlete.
We'll take a break, come back, more to go. Pirate Radio Live after this. Chico's Mexican restaurant is where the fiesta never ends. Grab your amigos and head to Chico's every Wednesday for shrimp tacos for $11.99. Plus, Wednesdays means all Mexican imports for just $2.99. Thursdays, enjoy your favorite beef, chicken, or vegetable fajitas for only $11.99. For Mexican food and fun, it's got to be Chico's Mexican restaurant in downtown Greenville and online at chicosrestaurant.com. Chico's, where the fiesta never ends.
Jeff Stein, our special guest from Brown & Wood. Hey, Jeff, electric cars are coming. What's that mean for Brown & Wood customers?
For the customers, like it or not, EV is coming. We've installed 5 electric vehicle chargers here at the dealership. We have the all-new Cadillac Lyriq coming at first of 2024, and we've just seen the first reservation for the new Sierra EV.
People are interested in electric vehicles. How can they get up with you?
They can visit us at brownandwood.net or 329 Southwest Greenville Boulevard. Brown & Wood, 4 brands, 3 generations, 2 rooftops, and 1 goal. To make sure you leave a happy customer.
Flight by Yuengling. It's the next generation of light beer. For those who don't follow trends, but craft them. Flight by Yuengling is 12 ounces of uncompromised refreshment from America's oldest brewery. With only 2.6 grams of carbs and 95 calories, this is premium refreshment 6 generations in the making. Don't just raise a glass. Raise the bar.
Flight by Yuengling. Available wherever beer is sold. DG Yuengling & Son Incorporated, Pottsville, Pennsylvania. Please enjoy responsibly.
If you wake up in the morning with a backache, feeling more tired than you did when you went to bed, you probably need a new mattress. And the best place to get that mattress is Factory Mattress. Hi, I'm Kirk Smith, General Manager. For more than 40 years, Factory Mattress has been Greenville and Wilson's local mattress dealer. We guarantee the lowest price on the area's best selection with over 50 models to choose from. No seconds or overruns. Factory Mattress offers only first quality direct from the manufacturer. Sealy Posturepedic, Beautyrest, Stearns & Foster, and Tempur-Pedic. The most highly trained sales associates with over 60 years of combined experience. Same as cash financing with zero interest up to 48 months and free local delivery. Face it, to have a good day, you've got to have a good night. So sleep better knowing you saved money at Factory Mattress, locally owned on Greenville Boulevard in Greenville, on Forest Hills Road in Wilson, on the web at factorymattressusa.com, and a proud member of Pirates Supporting Pirates.
Be sure to check out David Price Construction for all of your commercial or custom residential renovation and building needs. Run by ECU alumni, David Price Construction specializes in commercial projects, maintenance on facilities, and large-scale residential renovations and additions. Proud to be voted the Remodeler of the Year by the Home Builders Association of Raleigh-Wake County in 2018 and Best Business Commercial Remodel Project winner for 2020. David Price Construction, the proud ECU Home Services partner.
With over 30 locations across North Carolina and southeastern Virginia, Quality Equipment is your local John Deere dealer, where you'll find everything you need for your next project. Our complete lineup of John Deere lawn and garden, agricultural, and commercial worksite equipment comes with years of experience, expertise, and dedication. We know what it takes to get it done right. Stop by today or visit us online at qualityequip.com.
Wings Over Delivers. Wings Over Delivers. Wings Over Delivers. If you're looking for wings to be delivered to your home, Wings Over Greenville has you covered. With no third party needed, Wings Over Greenville has its own in-house delivery service. Be sure to try the all-new tender sandwiches by ordering ahead on the Wings Over mobile app. Open till 3 a.m. on Friday and Saturday, Wings Over has everything to cure those late night munchies. Give them a call at 758-9464. Wings Over Greenville. They deliver.
Pirate Radio sounds different.
Difference is good. We are all the same. You'll be ashamed.
Because different is good.
Oh, yeah.
Pirate Radio.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by First Bank. Together with our customers, we're creating a world where individuals and communities thrive. Visit the First Bank location on Arlington Boulevard in Greenville for all your personal and business banking needs. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? We'll keep it local and print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com, the official sportswear provider of Pirate Radio. Now, let's head back into the show. Here's Clip Rock.
Hey, thanks, Shirley. Chandler Honeycutt here. Mike Mullis hanging out one more segment. We got a big announcement coming up on Thursday. Redbeard says, as the mystery guest, Mark Lindsay, and he will have a new show called In Terms Of, starting soon. In Terms Of with Mark Lindsay. I was talking to Igo.
Match up against this particular ball club as you come into this week. That's a pretty, that could play, at the higher level, for sure.
For sure.
What do you turkeys got cooked up for Thanksgiving here?
I was talking to Igo last week. We're going to have Mark back on the show just to get an update. Talk some sports.
Get a life update.
But I like the idea of In Terms Of
with Mark Lindsay. For sure.
On Pirate Radio. Beginning.
The name of the show is In Terms Of with Mark Lindsay, for sure.
So Redbeard, I can tell you, no, that is not the big guest and big announcement coming up later this week.
I like your idea of doing like a detective.
Just dropping some clues?
Yeah.
You better be careful.
Yeah.
That's all I can tell you.
Look, they told me to talk about this stuff.
Yeah, no, it's a cool deal, but I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Got a big announcement.
There's a big announcement.
Thursday at 3.
Okay, so I'll go ahead and spill it. That way, if anybody takes the heat, it'll be me. There will be another edition of Name That Sound on Thursday.
Is that the announcement?
That's the announcement.
That'll keep them rushing to the doors there.
Did you listen to it, Molly?
I tried.
You tried?
I tried.
Why?
I would
love to hear your critique of the game show that I created.
Even at one point, Shirley, you were like, all right, let's just, instead of like going back and forth, let's just whoever comes in first. And I was like, thank you, Shirley. And the fact that neither one of these guys were getting layups, I'm like, what are we doing, guys? I regard both of you as reasonably intelligent young men, some younger than others, both reasonably intelligent. And it was, especially Clip, you led with the banner. Before it started, like you built your, like, hey, I'm a pop culture kind of guy, you know, and Chandler really doesn't have a chance. But so I thought, that would be a Mountain Dew can opening. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought we were playing right now.
this guy.
No, it was, yeah.
I thought it was going to be more like TV themes and stuff, but it was things I should have got that I didn't get. I mean, Netflix.
You guys missed the Netflix one, I'm like, man.
Yeah.
And it's because it was right there, and we knew. I even said, like, once you say it, it's going to, like, tear us apart.
Oh, I heard you.
And when she said Netflix, it was, man.
No, Shirley, the game, I get these two guys.
I think it would have been boring if we just named them immediately.
Yeah,
and moved
I think
on.
It made it even better. Than I think.
Okay. Well, don't worry about Shirley.
And people were playing at home. So.
Yeah. Well, Shirley, a lot of other people liked it. So
no, I said Molly, liked it. Did I not say I liked it?
Yeah, he said he liked the game. He thought
it. But
y'all underachieved greatly.
He thought that the contestants were subpar.
Chad wants to see Molly play.
Okay.
Chad also said, the hater Molly is back. I missed him.
Yeah, well, here I am. All right, tell me about this LIV Golf thing. I have not heard about this. Is this the Fox deal?
No, sir.
Wow, where are they going?
LIV.
Playboy TV.
So let me get the exact wording here. LIV Golf on the verge of announcing TV deal with blank. The TV agreement would fill a major objective for LIV Golf, as blank is in 220 U.S. markets, many of which have local news operation, website, and nightly newscast. Molly, what network am I speaking of?
Fox comes right to mind.
The CW.
Wow. That is super soft play by LIV.
The CW.
I mean, that doesn't even, I think that's on your TV and at like 106.5 or something, like, or, you know, like, that's okay.
And one of the local news runs on that as well.
Yeah,
right?
Like the super, like they're on their second news broadcast right now. Like they start showing the news at 4 o'clock or something.
So
the CW, that's like reruns of Andy Griffith and stuff. I mean, okay. Hey, it's a landing spot.
Yeah, it does seem pretty odd. It says multiple sources have told Sports Illustrated, CW Network, which is more known for syndicated programming, like you said, has no other sports properties, will agree to a multi-year agreement to broadcast LIV Golf events and related programming. So you're home for the LIV.
I wonder if the difference there is they were going to buy time on Fox and CW probably courted them. And maybe, you know, I mean, why not get in the sports game, right? And it just seems like everybody's got multiple platforms to show sports.
So Netflix had, I think they had a big F1 type documentary season thing that people enjoyed. Now they have a tennis one that's out available.
Match Point, yeah.
And coming up in February, they're going to have the PGA Tour where they talked to golfers, but filmed their behind the scenes season last year, which people are excited about. So even things like that, like Netflix, not in the live sporting game, but Prime's got live events. Apple TV does the Major League Baseball.
Is it anybody else? But the feed on Prime is terrible. Like it's super glitchy, and I don't think it's my internet speed.
I thought mine went pretty smooth.
Did you?
Okay. I don't know. So. I had Dan Campbell on the roof fixing mine.
Did you? Yeah.
He got it going.
Well, he's the man.
So, LIV, that's one way to get me at least talking about it if I pass it on TV or something. because it's like out of sight, out of mind otherwise for me.
Yeah,
I follow Harold kind of, sort of, but that's about it. I don't know.
Yeah, and you know what? It's not even, like, even with Harold, it's not super intriguing. Like, it used to be, all right, where did Harold finish? Oh, he finished, you know, eighth. Well, how much money did he make? Because all that plays into, you know, your next stop, your status on the PGA Tour. Now it's like, oh, where did Harold, he finished eighth, okay. You know, it's kind of, all right.
Oh, right.
And then the next comment is, man, well, at least he got paid. And that's, but there you go.
Because the climb was fun to follow. When can he get into these majors? Yeah. When can he qualify for the Masters? And now there isn't any of that.
No, well, and so I think we're three events deep this going into the third this weekend on PGA Tour. I can tell you collectively, I maybe have watched nine holes.
Well, is that? I mean, it's this time of year. There's football, basketball.
Yeah, but typically that Hawaiian tournament, the open to the tournament champions, that, man, that's a lot of fun because you always have winners playing. So it's, you know, but now, you're missing half the field, you know, half the field that makes it interesting. So, I mean, it just nothing to get real excited about.
Mike Mullis joining us. Anything else on the docket, Molly?
No, nothing I can think of. The Down East pitcher catcher camp.
Ryan Meadows will join us Thursday,
28th.
You involved?
I am. I'll, whatever Coach Meadows needs me to do. I guess Coach Meadows has taken his talents to Lenoir Community College, at least in a some you know what I don't know how he gets done. All he gets done, but you know, he took some time to go over there and help those guys, and I'll be a. Be a good addition with Coach Smith in the crowd with the Lancers.
Breaking news, boy, Chandler Honeycutt told me about that. I had not heard of that. Yeah. So we'll talk to Ryan about that on Thursday. I asked RV, Ronald Vinson, when he was here for the Brian Bailey Show yesterday, if he would be involved in that. And he said he's going to have to miss it this year because, and now, I can't remember, is it Ryan Gordon?
Yeah, Rhino.
Is going to be inducted into
UNC Greensboro.
And He told Coach RV that he struck me out a few times back in the day.
Yeah.
Playing in like a Greenville, Winterville all-star deal.
Sure. You didn't handle him?
I did not.
You were on a long list.
Did not get a bat on it.
He's
so
good. It'll be weird not having RV there. And I guess I know you mentioned Shilty earlier. I guess the hot stove is this coming Thursday too as well, maybe? I think that's right. But always a fun time.
Let me get that exact date and find out when that is. So, Mike Shildt will be speaking this year, the former Cardinals manager. It's that time of year. Start to get baseball rolling, Mully, along with your NFL playoffs, college hoops. Big bad news for ECU basketball with Javon Small being out. It's going to be a tough sledding. It was tough sledding before and even tougher now.
It doesn't get any easier, and that's isn't it weird how teams start out and things, you know, you get real excited. I mean, that's the beauty of sports. You get fired up and you feel like things are trending in the right direction, and then, you know, one injury or one mishap or whatever, and it's like, well, you know, here we go again. Yep. So but hopefully hopefully they can get it turned around and, you know, kind of figured out. It's again, this, you know, it's just not going to get any easier.
That it won't. All right, Molly, thanks for hanging out today with us. By the way, talking about West Charlotte, Newton says he graduated from West Charlotte in 1986. Go Lions.
Yeah, he's a little before me.
He said Steve Wilkes, class of 87. So, we talk a lot of West Charlotte sports when Molly comes in.
Well,
or at least about the legends.
Well, and if it wasn't relevant, we would. I mean, it's not like we're bringing up Harry High School stuff. We're talking about Steve Wilkes, who's, you know, a head coach in the NFL, at least for right now. We're talking about a guy who's a big league manager.
Where are we at on that, Chandler? I asked Tony Friday, is Steve Wilkes going to get a fair shot to get the job? And he said no.
It's weird to me. It seems like they've interviewed everybody but, like, the, you know, us. I mean, it seems like they have interviewed tons of people, or at least names keep coming up.
Well, Sean Payton said that he was interviewing for the job this week.
He has interviewed everywhere.
Yeah, it'll be Thursday, I believe, that Sean Payton – I mean, that's the latest news right now, is that earlier this week it was that Sean Payton – we got permission to interview Sean Payton. He will be interviewed later this week. And then there's also interviews being conducted with like potential defensive coordinators, which is kind of getting people, you know, getting their mind working. Like, all right, what does this mean? Where's the connection with this guy? Some of them are connections with Sean Payton. Some of them are connections with Steve Wilkes. So it's just still kind of in the air right now, but we shall see.
I mean, why would Sean Payton come to Carolina? He is the most coveted coach right now that's out there.
Well, you got to look at what jobs are available. Where would he go? Where's a better landing spot for him? Would you want to go to Denver with Russell?
I would think Arizona would be a better spot. I mean, none of them are wonderful.
I guess the thought is like you're hungry to build something. I don't know. Some coach.
And I think the problem there too is the ownership in Charlotte. I don't know that that's conducive to building something.
If the Cowboys get throttled next week, which I can see that happen, like does Mike McCarthy get the axe, and then does that open up the biggest door of them all, the Dallas Cowboys, to Sean Payton?
Should Sean Payton go through some back channels and say, "Hey, I'd love to coach Justin Herbert if you happen to get rid of Brandon Staley."
I mean. and that's not a bad play for him.
Yeah.
You're coming into really, at least you feel like, you know what, if nothing else, if you're with the Cardinals, the weather's pretty good.
I've heard this point though, if you take that Panthers job and you look around you, who's got the brightest future in the NFC South? The answer would be nobody.
I was going to say, I don't even know how you answer.
Nobody.
But you have as good a shot as anybody right now in that division.
That's just such a bad division.
It's terrible. They should not. Is that the kind of product y'all put out in the South? We don't do that in the NFC East, Chandler. Mm. That was disgusting.
No, you did it last year, but what a turnaround that division had.
Yeah.
Because it was one of the best, if not the best.
Trivia question: on this day in 1999, this team upset the Vikings 30-27 in overtime in the NFC Championship game. What NFC team went on to the Super Bowl after upsetting Randall Cunningham or Randy Moss and the Vikings after a Gary Anderson missed field goal?
The Redskins.
Hell no. It was the Dirty Birds, the Falcons. Oh. Kind of a random rumor.
Yeah, man.
And then they got,
you know, they were good for like 10 minutes.
Jamal Anderson, and they would do the dancing. And
Even going back to the, you know, Jamal Anderson.
It was a very random. Chris Chandler was their quarterback, and they ended up getting wrecked by the Broncos in the Super Bowl. Molly, thanks for hanging out.
Yep, enjoyed it.
We'll see you next time. Chandler, we'll see you next segment, Shirley as well, when we return on Pirate Radio Live. Hour 2 rolls on. We're back with you after this.
Hey, Pirate Nation, Lindsey Gray here with Carolina Caliber. In 1960, my granddaddy started his firearm business right here in Eastern NC. Still family-owned and operated, we have the area's largest selection for outdoor shooting sports and accessories and are one of the nation's top firearm dealers. At Carolina Caliber, we have everything you need from hunting, home defense, and personal protection, including a wide variety for ladies and youth. We buy, sell, and trade. It's a time-honored tradition. Visit us at Carolina Caliber on Fire Tower Road in Winterville.
Familia on Fire Tower Road in Winterville has a brand new updated menu. Open from 4 to 9 Tuesday through Saturday and 11 to 9 on Sundays, Familia has a variety of pizza combinations and classic Italian dishes that are sure to tackle your taste buds. Enjoy Thirsty Thursdays with $3 drafts with several local brews on tap. And who doesn't love brunch? Familia has Sunday brunch from 11 to 2. Follow Familia on social media for their pizza of the week for just $12. Visit online at FamiliaNC.com. Familia, that's Italian for family.
UVE and PirateWear.com is excited to offer Pirate Nation the largest selection of new ECU merchandise and tailgate supplies ever. UVE has the best prices in town, so that makes UVE your one-stop shop for all things ECU. UVE does daily restocks of Champion, Adidas, and Under Armour. Don't forget to bring your young Pirates in to plunder the Crow's Nest, which is the only kid store dedicated to ECU. Plenty of free parking uptown in Greenville. Visit them at PirateWear.com. Go Pirates!
The best burgers around. Everyone loves a thick, juicy, and fresh burger.
Tiebreakers in Greenville, plus the all-new Tiebreakers in Winterville do real burgers better than anybody. So don't just go to any burger-themed restaurant chain. It's time to break the chain and eat local. Tiebreakers, real burgers at its best.
Everybody loves burgers.
Before anyone walks into your business, the outside is what they see. Make sure your first impression is a good impression with the right curb appeal. Hi, this is Daniel Andrews from Dan Andrews Lawn Service. We specialize in making your business look great. Let us handle all your professional landscaping needs. We do it all so you don't ever have to worry. Residential services are also available. Call us today at 717-8006 and we'll come out and give you a free quote. Taking care of your landscaping needs is all we do, and we've been doing it for over 20 years. You can trust our reliable team at Dan Andrews Lawn Service covering all of Eastern North Carolina.
You've worked hard to make your business successful, and that's why it's really important to always have a bank in your corner when you need them. This is former ECU baseball player Ashley Capps from First Bank, and our experienced team of local bankers includes Lee Watson, Bonner Latham, Chris Richards, Josh Hooten, and Heath Nisbet. To get the business services that are right for your business today, come and see someone on our team at First Bank on Arlington Boulevard here in Greenville. First Bank, together with our customers, we're creating a world where individuals and communities thrive.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
This is Holt Naylors. I've been eating at Parker's Barbecue since I was a kid. Now, all these years later, I still love to eat at Parker's. In fact, I love it so much, I bring my entire offensive line with me. They protect me, and I look out for them with great food from Parker's Barbecue. So whether you bring the team like me, or just your friends and family, the awesome barbecue, chicken, and seafood at Parker's is a win every time. Parker's Barbecue, where they always treat you like family.
Add some sparkle and style to your home and save at Bostic Sugg Furniture. Give your home a new look in a new year with beautiful new furniture. Right now, get a Bostic Sugg first time ever offer with three ways to save. One, get a sales tax discount on any purchase. Two, get a $100 in MasterCard rewards cards for every $1,000 you spend. And finally, get 6 months special financing. So add some sparkle and style to your home with a little help from Bostic Sugg Furniture.
This is Big John Williams, strength and conditioning coach for East Carolina football, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by First Bank. Together with our customers, we're creating a world where individuals and communities thrive. Visit the First Bank location on Arlington Boulevard in Greenville for all your personal and business banking needs. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back for the latest breaking news, interesting stories, and awesome contests that can make you a winner. Be sure to follow Pirate Radio on our social media. You can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at PR927FM. And if you're following us on Twitter, we just put up on our social media, the American Athletic Conference has released their preseason coaches poll. East Carolina selected to be first in baseball. So, D1 baseball that released their preseason rankings earlier today, and the Pirates are ranked 11th in the nation. So we'll see what Baseball America has to say at some point. Anyway, you can join the over 61,000 followers today. Now let's head back into the show. Here's Cliff.
Join us. Join the cult of Pirate Radio.
Yes, and if you're watching this on YouTube, click that subscribe button. Smash the like button while you're at it. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter and all that stuff, and you can keep up to date.
Let's, while we're on the topic, let's get those numbers up.
Yes.
On YouTube, we have 16 more watching than we do likes, so all you got to do is hit that like, and while you're there, hit a subscribe as well. It'll help us out. And the Cult of Pirate Radio, we don't have meetings, we don't have any juice you got to drink or robes you got to wear or anything like that. We're not going to ask you to sacrifice anything.
Or write blood on the wall or anything.
Nah, nothing weird like that. All, you just become a part of the family.
Family.
That's all it is. Shirley, you enjoying those peanuts?
Uh-huh. courtesy of Bo Batts.
Thank you, Bo.
Thanks, Bo.
Thanks, Bo, because this keeps my late day cravings.
We still have Cheez-Its in the back.
They're gone.
Oh no, I ate those.
Man,
did you ever get any?
Yeah, I had a few.
Oh, okay.
Did you get any?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
I might have.
I wasn't the only one that ate them, so don't just, you know.
I'm not like that. I share with the class.
Look,
we appreciate.
I'm hungry. I'm a big girl. I'm hungry.
If I leave food in the kitchen, then, you know, it's fair game. I would be upset if y'all eat my lunch or something, but
even though some of the stuff you bring in here looks really good,
a little tasty, yeah. Kenny Curling said, "Clip, did you pick my Cowboys last night?" I did, Kenny. I did. I can put my hatred aside for a smart pick. And I did pick Dallas last night. Punt fest early on, and that offense finally got going. Tampa's offense never got going last night. Ugly one. I will pick against Dallas this week when they take on
your
49ers. I do think that's going to be a good game, though.
Is that hat in it? Is that hat?
I never ordered it.
Oh, you didn't?
I almost made a...
I was going to say, like, it could be...
But I still plan to. It's a sweet hat. I like the Niners classic logo. They're sucking me in, man. I've never had another NFL team, and I don't. I mean, I'm a Washington fan, but they make me so mad. I mean, we are... Ron Rivera not starting Carson Wentz in a game against Cleveland and then a Washington upset over San Francisco from an all NFC East Final Four. Think about that. NFC East versus NFC East versus NFC East versus NFC East. We're not that far from that happening this year. But I don't know. You think the Giants can hang with the Eagles? I wrote the Giants off all year.
When's the true colors going to be shown?
I think they have been shown. They're a pretty good team.
I think it would be tough for Daniel Jones to have as much leeway as he did in terms of running the football. I don't think he's going to have as much leeway with Philadelphia. I mean, you've got a pretty staunch defensive line there. They're not going to give him too much room to try to take off and scramble.
Yeah, we might revert back to the old Daniel Jones. Daniel Jones, let me look at the his turnovers, and I don't know if it's going to have fumbles readily available to me. But what he's done this year is just erase the big back-breaking mistakes. And if you got a punt, then punt, but don't just give the ball away. Let's see, his career numbers. So interceptions, 12 as a rookie to 10 to 7. How about this year, 5 picks for Daniel Jones? Mm-hmm. That is a great number for a quarterback. Can I get some fumble numbers? This year, he had 1, 2, 3 fumbles lost, which is way down from what he had his previous years. And I will try to find those numbers. But here we go. As a rookie, so this year he had 6 fumbles, I guess 3 lost. He fumbled 7 times last year, 10 times in 2020. Here's where the reputation began. Here's why I look at him the way I do. When he was a rookie, he had 19 fumbles.
Jeez.
Yeah, he was constantly coughing up the football.
He was butterfingers.
You have to try to fumble that much. So that's why he got the reputation. That's why I look at him the way I do.
Well, he has certainly improved in that category.
Pro Football Reference includes nicknames. So it says Daniel Jones, parentheses, Danny Dimes or Vanilla Vic.
No way. No, it doesn't. Really?
Yeah, I'm reading it right now.
Wow.
Vanilla Vic is a really cool nickname.
My roommate, speaking of Vanilla Vic, my roommate came in the house the other day and he said, "Was Daniel Jones like running the football really good today? Because I saw all over Twitter, like the caption would be Daniel Jones right now, and it's like a highlight video of Michael Vick running around doing what he used to do." And I mean, he does for his frame. He is a very, he's got speed. He can move.
Speed.
God, can we get a Gus Johnson called playoff game, please?
We need to do some. I hate this. Al Michaels has kind of lost a step. He sounded so bored the other night.
I believe it was Dave Portnoy who put it on Twitter. He said, "This is the call. It was when Jacksonville came back and won against the Chargers. And, I mean, Al Michaels' call was just kind of like it was a field goal to cut the lead to the three, you know.
He's still got the classic voice and everything, but he just seems uninterested.
Yeah,
I don't
there's
know.
No enthusiasm.
Mike Tirico is all in, 100%. I mean, he killed it. I wish Tony Romo could do color on every game. He's so good.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe I'm
here we go, Jim.
I can't believe I'm a Romo fan. Certainly wasn't on the field, but I am as an announcer. He's great.
This could be the game right here, Jim.
And I didn't listen to Buck and Aikman last night, nor did you.
No.
But I guess they're done. Usually we hear, you know, we're used to hearing Joe Buck throughout the NFC Championship, sometimes in the Super Bowl, depending on the network. But I guess they're done for the year.
Yeah, that was their finale last night.
Unless the Super Bowl is on ABC. Who's carrying the Super Bowl this year?
I've never been – I wasn't a fan of Troy Aikman as a football player, but he is a very good color commentator.
When was the last time the Super Bowl was on, like, an ESPN broadcast?
I feel like it's been on, like, ABC maybe. This year it's on Fox. And I got to say, I'm not a huge Burkhart fan.
That's who's going – that's well, I guess
I like Greg Olsen. Greg Olsen will be calling it this year. Let me see if I can answer your question, though, Chandler. So last year – it was on NBC, so you had Michaels and Collinsworth. There are a lot of Collinsworth haters out there. I get that he's kind of annoying, but I am a Collinsworth fan.
I've always been a fan of Collinsworth.
It was CBS the year before that. Fox, I don't know. I got to I'll see if I can find one here that was on ABC. It might have been a long time ago now. But anyway, so what's your who's your favorite broadcast team going right now? By the way, you can hear the Super Bowl right here on Pirate Radio.
Ooh, I'd probably go Nance and Romo.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm like you. Romo, the way he breaks things down, it's unbelievable. And the way he's been known for it now, basically ever since he started being in the booth.
He's very
like Colin plays. Like,
oh, yeah. He does He'll sit that. There and say, oh, yeah, watch this guy.
Like they're going to run to the left here, Jim.
But he's very honest, too. Like, you get a score here, you got a chance, and then the team turns it over, and he's like, well, that's it. That's all she wrote for the. Like, he's pretty honest calling a game.
Yeah.
I'm still stalling to try to find an ABC Super Bowl.
And I mean, like, obviously, I grew up because, I mean, a lot of Panthers games were on Fox, so I kind of grew up listening to Joe Buck and Troy Aikman because even if they weren't the broadcasters for the Panthers game, I usually tuned into the game afterwards for the game of the week, and it usually was them. So, and I know a lot of people do not like Joe Buck. More in the baseball world,
I'm kind of up and down with Joe Buck.
So...
the last Super Bowl on ABC, who was on the call?
It had to have been like the classic.
So it would have been like the Monday Night Football crew. This was February 5th, 2006.
Oh.
Steelers beat the Seahawks.
2006 Monday Night crew.
It was Al Michaels and John Madden.
John Madden.
Yep. So that I guess that was might have been Madden's last year. Michelle Tafoya and Susie Colbert.
John Madden's last year was actually 2010.
Really?
Cardinals and Steelers. Wait.
Huh. Okay. I'll look that up real quick.
Yeah, please, because I think that's right. I think he called a Super Bowl. Of course, it wasn't. I can't remember. I want to say it was the 2000.
Oh, wow. Cardinals, yeah. Al Michaels, John Madden, Andrew Kramer, Alex Flanagan. Good call. Hey, sports guy.
I know my John Madden.
Sports guy is
back. It's a
Trebekin. What a call there.
Like, boom.
So there you go. Chad asking me, have I seen this Bojangles Hard Sweet Tea? I've seen some stuff on social media about it.
Yes, I have seen it. I don't know if they're a sponsor for us anymore. So. Hesitant to say something.
Why did chicken cross the road? Because.
Well, oh. It would give a whole new definition to that one commercial with the chicken dancing.
Oh, God. They used to show it at Dowdy Ficklin Stadium every year. And people loved it.
I had a Troy D style dumb joke that I said off the air. I'll say it on the air. Let me see if I can remember it now. Action stars of the 80s wanted to get together and make an action film about composers. Is that the word I'm looking for, Shirley?
What's that? Oh, so that again?
That joke I told you? Composers?
Yes, composers.
So Steven Seagal said, "I'll be Mozart." And Jean-Claude Van Damme said, "I'll be Beethoven." And Arnold Schwarzenegger jumped in and said, "I'll be Bach." Oh, that's a great joke. That is a great, great joke. Jerry says, do you have to make a lifetime commitment to pirate radio? Will I get criticized if I enter the portal and seek out another station? I tell you what, Jerry, just join us now, subscribe, be a part of the family. If you choose to leave, we
will respect that, but we will say that you're not a true pirate radio member.
If you put out a social media post with a cool graphic saying respect my decision, and with that being said,
plenty of talks with my family.
So I tell you what, just sign up now, Jerry, and we'll worry about that next year or when you leave. Frank Brown, good information, said the Super Bowl is coming to ESPN in 2 years. That's why they hired Joe Buck and Troy Aikman. Good info there. He also said ABC lasted the Super Bowl when they had Monday Night Football in the mid-2000s. That is correct. We looked that up. Thank you, Frank, for that information. Well, we got some questions. Mike says, what are your thoughts on NBA teams constantly changing the color of their courts and jerseys? Seems to be taking me a minute or so to figure out who's playing unless I look at the scorebook. That is true. I don't love it.
I like it when they go retro. Like the Jazz went retro with their jerseys and their floor. Like that I don't mind, but like the random colors that some of these teams are doing, like you said, if you're not looking at the score bug, then you have no idea who's playing.
This is kind of like the NIL transfer portal, all that stuff. I don't complain about it anymore because it's the reality, it's the life we live in. Why complain? It's not changing. It's not going back to the way it was for any time in the foreseeable future. So there's no use in complaining about it. I have to do the same thing with uniforms. I like, you know, baseball, white at home, gray on the road. Well, now teams just wear whatever color. Basketball, white at home, your, you know, solid color on the road. We don't see that anymore. Football, a lot of teams used to wear the their dark jerseys at home. Washington for years wore white at home, and the road team would wear a colored uniform. But now, I mean, everything is whatever. They're trying to sell uniforms. They make alternate jerseys. They make city edition. They make throwbacks. They make all kinds of stuff. So the courts are weird. I love when Charlotte goes with the old honeycomb and the old court look. Mm-hmm. It looks good. But it's all a money grab.
Yeah. And now these jerseys are sponsored too. Like they add the patches to the jersey with a sponsorship. By the way, Hornets,
I don't really care about that.
By the way, Hornets and Linden Tree are parting ways. They will not be the official jersey sponsor for the Hornets. Me and my roommate were talking about potential new sponsorships for the jerseys. We were talking about maybe Bojangles being a sponsor. He came up and said Krispy Kreme being a sponsor for the Hornets. He said Cheerwine. Something, you know, I thought that was a cool conversation we had.
That would be cool. Have that on the unis. Jansen says, let's spark a debate. Joe Buck is unbearably awful. Just terrible. Okay.
I mean, I'm not going to argue.
We got to take a break. We'll come back and discuss more announcing duos and more with Bryce Williams, who will join us inside the Pirate Radio studios. Hour three, Pirate Radio Live. We'll be back with you after this.
The Buccaneer Music Hall is your beacon of music in the land of pirates. The doors open at noon, 7 days a week. And the Buck has live music every night, along with football. Monday is open mic night, the first Monday of each month. Tuesday, it's karaoke with DJ Captain Morgan. Wednesday, it's acoustic night. Thursday, it's the dance party with DJ Kid Scene. And live music every Friday and Saturday night with the best bands on the East Coast. Follow the Buck on Instagram for information and schedule of events. This season, party like a pirate at the Buck.
Happy New Year. This is Talbot Green, and I'm excited to announce our new partnership with Integrity Home Mortgage. Integrity Home Mortgage offers a wide variety of programs ranging from conventional, government, and portfolio loans, plus construction and lot loans. Our Integrity Home Mortgage team of Talbot Green, Braxton Green, and Joanne Weir offer over 50 years of experience and is committed to providing you with superior customer service. To get started, call me, Talbot Green, 714-2076.
NMLS 28516, Equal Housing Lender.
Greenville Utilities Electric customers will soon be able to receive text notifications in the event of power outages. Enrollment is automatic, so make sure GUC has your cell phone number by signing into your account at GUC.com, then update the information in your user profile. Want to talk with someone instead? Call 252-752-7166 during business hours. 252-752-7166. Update us so we can update you. Visit GUC.com for more information.
Uptown Greenville's newest dining experience is open and ready to serve you. The Sidebar, a Tex-Mex fusion restaurant, offers lunch, dinner, and Sunday brunch from 10:30 to 2:30. Located right beside the Dickinson Avenue Public House, the Sidebar has indoor dining and patio seating for everyone to enjoy. For the latest information on reservations, menu items, and more, follow the Sidebar on Facebook or on Instagram at sidebar.greenville.
Hey Pirate Nation, this is Amanda Houston, and when it came time to make the game-winning play for relaxation at our house, I made the right call to Jamie Lang and Carolina Hardscapes. Jamie and his team built the backyard oasis of our dreams with a beautiful custom paver patio, outdoor lighting, and fireplace. Make your backyard incredible and call Carolina Hardscapes today at 364-1201 or visit their showroom on Fire Tower Road across from Bostic Suck. Go Pirates!
Winslow's is now Fifth Street Hardware Restaurant and Tap Room. With a brand new look, Fifth Street Hardware also has a new menu and serving lunch and dinner every Tuesday through Sunday and brunch starting at 10:30 on Sundays. What else is new? Well, they have poker every Tuesday night, Trivia Wednesday with DJ Captain Morgan, and on Friday and Saturday nights, they have live music open till 2 a.m. serving light appetizers all night long. New look, new name, same location on Fifth Street. Follow them on Facebook and Instagram for more specials. Fifth Street Hardware Restaurant and Tap Room.
Russell's Clothing in downtown Washington is celebrating 40 years in business. That means big savings for you on your favorite men's and women's clothing and accessories. As you would expect, Rhonda has slashed prices 40% on select merchandise. Outerwear, slacks, assorted sportswear, and shoes for the men. Dresses, sweaters, blouses, and outerwear for the ladies. Celebrate 40 years with us and save 40% while it lasts. We're here because of you, and we thank you, our friends and customers at Russell's Clothing in downtown Washington.
Do you have any real estate questions about buying or selling residential or commercial properties? Are you curious about this current real estate market? Do you need a property manager for all your rental houses? This is proud ECU alum Scott Harris with RE/MAX Preferred Realty and SD Harris Properties, and I would love to help answer every question you have and show you a real estate experience that will be memorable and enjoyable. Every step of the way, I'm here to make your dreams a stress-free reality. Call me today at 347-1857. That's 347-1857. Go Pirates!
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250, and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930, and 104.1 FM Washington. You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Bud Light, reminding Pirate fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Hey, Pirate Nation, Integrity Home Mortgage is here. If you're looking to purchase a home, contact Talbot Green, Braxton Green, and Joanne Weir today. The Integrity Home Mortgage team offers over 50 years of experience and is committed to providing you with the superior customer service you deserve before, during, and after your real estate transaction. To get started, contact Talbot Green, Braxton Green, or Joanne Weir, Integrity Home Mortgage, Pirates supporting Pirates. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Clip Brock.
All right. Shirley eating those peanuts made me want peanuts. So I went and got some peanuts.
All right.
I just went and grabbed a handful myself.
What a classic snack.
Yeah.
Well, it takes that edge off of your hunger, you know?
Yeah. Protein, right?
But
yeah.
Man, it makes me thirsty.
Well, that's why you get drinks while you get the peanuts.
Yeah.
That's why I keep the refrigerator stocked.
Thank you for that.
Shirley, hit the bad news music bed. Remember this?
Oh, that brings back memories.
Bad memories.
This game's canceled. This person has COVID. Ugh.
I thought we were done with this.
Oh, no.
But apparently we're not.
Oh, no.
Tomorrow night's game, basketball game between Iowa and Northwestern, will not be played due to COVID-19 health and safety protocols.
No way!
Within the Northwestern program, according to John Rothstein.
Are you sure that's not a tweet from like 2 years ago?
Yeah, this was tweeted out earlier today, 11:32 a.m.
Isn't it something
they're still
like
testing?
They only have six guys.
Wow.
That's it. That are eligible to play.
I did not know.
It's a trap.
I never knew that was in the
song. Because we never went that far. It's a remix.
It's a trap.
Pew pew pew. This is Larry. What's your favorite character from Star Wars? Mine was always Admiral. I'd like to buy a vowel. Admiral Akbar.
The greatest line
in the history of Star Wars. It's a trap.
A lot of people tuned into the football game last night to see the Mandalorian trailer.
Which I saw. It's really good. I can't wait.
I'm not a Star Wars nut. As I eat a nut. But
name that sound.
I did like the Mandalorian.
I like that. I like the I'm a traditionalist. I love my Star Wars. I like that timeline. When they start splitting off, I sometimes have a little trouble with it because I'm like, you know, I loved the original Star Wars trilogy so much. But I have to say, I love The Mandalorian. The Book of Boba Fett was good. I like that. So I'm pretty excited. I think March 1st is when the new season comes out. So I'm pretty excited about it.
Looking forward to that. Let's welcome in our favorite guy in the galaxy. He is Bryce Williams.
I saw the light. I was baptized by the fire in your touch and the flame in your eyes. I'm born to love again. I'm a brand new man.
What's up, Bryce?
Hey, hey.
Gray day in eastern North Carolina.
Gray
day. Did the sun ever make its way out to peek out at us today?
I don't think it ever did.
Yeah.
Come out for a wink.
I just saw this, Bryce. This is from Jeremy Markovich, journalist in North Carolina. Looks like maybe the western part of the state. He says there was a police chase this morning in Boone involving a John Deere tractor.
I just saw this.
World. Lasted for more than an hour, topped out at 20 miles per hour. Whoa, he's losing it.
You guys squirming
fishtailing.
What in the world?
Now, is this your standard four-wheel John Deere tractor, or is it like one of those zero-turn mowers?
This is like a tractor.
Yeah.
Oh, like a farm tractor.
Yep.
Oh.
And he is scooting on down the road. How did he almost lose it here, Bryce?
It's on the back. He went to go do, maybe he kind of outmaneuver him.
Going 20. So there you go.
I mean, the only way you outmaneuver a police officer in a tractor is if you jump a ditch.
Yeah, you're going to have to go off-road. And I guess,
I mean, those wheels are made for off-road.
I'd be real curious.
He's still going. You have to fast forward the video to like see any kind of advance in the story. Yeah. And like, you fast
that is
forward
the
and
slowest yeah. high speed chase you've ever
Try
seen.
Try to see what happens at this light. I guess
does he run it or does he stop?
I think he goes right through the light.
See, now they got him for that. They ain't getting him for speeding, but they're getting him for running a red light and reckless driving that way.
So there you go. Be careful your trackers.
I would love to know the backstory behind that.
Yeah, we'll have to follow up. We talk about these stories and we never follow
no,
up.
No, we don't.
I hope Jeremy Markovich does follow. You know, gets a little more deeper into this story.
Yeah,
we got a lot of curious people out there.
All right, Bryce. Did you watch any football this weekend?
That's a no. I saw the highlights.
Yeah.
I saw big when was the Jaguars?
That was Saturday night.
So yeah, I saw that.
Zay running wide open with nobody around him for a touchdown.
Saw that, and then the Bronco Bucks Cowboys saw Brady lose. And
again, this is like,
who else played?
This is complete sports talk. Radio time filler, but like, can Brady retire already? Like,
you know, I was thinking about that. I would think he would be done, but now he's got a girlfriend, a young new girlfriend. He may play till he's 50.
I mean, again, he set a personal, I think, completions record this year. Last night, the Bucks offense was awful. Like, they couldn't do anything. Mm. He still had 351 passing yards. He threw the ball 66 times.
Jeez.
I mean, that is insane.
Wow.
And he had a chance to go out on top. You don't think he wants to go out this way. Yeah. I'm kind of interested to see what the Bucs look like next year.
Right,
I mean, Todd Bowles, that was an awful year from them. They had a losing record.
Yeah.
They made the playoffs because they're in a bad division. So do they go a different direction with the head coach? Does Tom Brady want to try to find a better spot for him to win now?
Yeah.
You know, I don't know.
I suppose he heard at the gym this morning that, was it Las Vegas? He may go.
Well,
there.
Derek Carr is moving on from the Raiders. So, yeah, they have an opening.
Where's Derek going?
Good question.
I like, it's funny, I brought up Derek as in like a personal, I said, where's Derek going?
Yeah, y'all on a first name basis?
Yeah, it felt like a
Oh, DC? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Where's DC? I ain't talked to him in a while.
I need to text him. See where he's going.
You got connections. You could probably, wonder how many people it would take you to text to get up with Derek Carr. Who's the most famous person in your phone, Bryce?
I'd have to go through probably, had Martellus Bennett, Coach. Did I? Fit? I don't think I had. I never got Gronk's number. I'd have to go through it.
Marty B.
Did I have Jared's number? Oh yeah, I got Jared Goff's number. I don't know if it's his current number, but
right.
When I was in LA,
might have changed now. So you got some digits.
I got
in there.
John Walford's number. I probably got a few.
So you have two quarterbacks that started, at least two.
Mm-hmm.
You got Jimmy G's? He's probably got like three phones.
He might have three phones. I have to go through and, I got, Kamu, my buddy Kamu. I did. I don't know how you spell Kamu.
What is Kamu?
Kamu, he was a linebacker. Yeah, I got Kamu Grugier Hill, who started linebacker. I was with him at the Patriots.
Okay.
DJ Foster.
You got some names in there.
I got some names in there.
I'm not going to ask you to call any of them.
Yeah, I don't know. They may not even work. I got you used to have, I don't know if it's his active number, Brian Daboll.
The coach of the Giants?
Yeah.
Who was he with?
He was my position coach at the Titans. Patriots. I got his number.
Brian Daboll. I was saying some mean things about him watching the game, Chandler.
Yeah, I got him.
I was calling him a fat. I was mad. I was speaking out of line. I got to give him credit, though. They are still playing, Bryce. It'll be the Giants and the Eagles this week.
Yeah.
As they remain alive. Jacksonville had that crazy comeback against LA, so they play the Chiefs. The 49ers took care of the Seahawks. They'll play the Cowboys coming up this weekend. And then good one between Burrow and Allen, Bengals and Bills coming up this weekend. So
I think
those are the matchups.
I'm trying to decide who had favor on the Bengals and Bills. I don't really know. I mean, I met Josh Allen, did a workout with him, but my buddy Mike Hilton and the ECU, Smith.
Deontay, yeah.
Deontay. I'll probably have to go Bengals. Probably Bengals.
You like to use, like, personal relationships mm-hmm. as to how you make your selections.
Pretty much, yeah.
Which is why you always pick ECU in football games. Let's recap some of our top stories of the day. East Carolina has announced a home-and-home with Liberty.
What's a home-and-home?
We'll play one time there. They'll play one time here. 2024, we'll go there.
Liberty.
2029, they'll come here.
They're pretty good, aren't they?
They are. They have a good program. Yeah. They just lost their coach, Hugh Freeze, but they brought in Jamie Chadwell from Coastal Carolina, the team we just beat in the bowl game. So he will join that team and try to continue their winning ways. So home and home there beginning in 2024. Your thoughts on that series?
I mean, I guess I never played Liberty. I know obviously they had
ECU's never played Liberty.
Never played them. I mean, I know they had that, first round quarterback.
Malik Willis, yeah.
Yes, I mean, that's about really how I pay attention to him. Of course, I've always known who Liberty is. I mean, I'd like a cooler.
Right.
You know, agreement or contract between two teams. But, you know, obviously it's an opportunity to play a different opponent and hopefully win back-to-back games because they're FBS now.
Yes, they're joining Conference USA.
So, personally, I'd like to see a little cooler home-and-home, but.
You know, it is kind of funny we mentioned that now. So 2024, if you'd have looked at this schedule 20 years ago, maybe 15 years ago, you would have seen all FCS opponents. Norfolk State at Old Dominion, App State at Liberty. Mm. And now it's Norfolk State in the FCS and the other three teams FBS.
Huh.
So that's 2024, 24. Yep.
I hope we got them next year.
Yeah, Marshall will be here. App will be on the road.
I ain't seen that one. I don't got to go to that one.
Mm-hmm. Bryce will be in Boone. Now, 2024.
That one, Marshall.
Oh, Marshall here. Okay. I thought you were pointing at the other one.
Oh, no.
You got a big finger.
Yeah.
You were covering up all the games. 2024 is when the new playoff format begins, I believe, where you'll have the highest ranked group of five team that wins their conference championship in the playoffs.
So everybody's got a chance.
Right. So the question is, like, do you want to load it up with a – you know, like a money game at Florida or what? Or would you rather play maybe four winnable games and you head into conference play 4-0 and not to say that's going to be their record, but it does kind of maybe change your strategy now that you have a chance to to be one of those teams at the end.
It's always cool playing a cool money game, but then again, what matters is the record.
Yeah.
So, you know. I mean, obviously, respectable wins. Every win's good, but
I like these teams on the future schedule. So, 2025, NC State, Marshall on the road, BYU here at home.
We got BYU again.
Yep, back one more time. 2026, App State at Boise on the blue turf.
Oh, that'll be cool. Yeah,
and West, by God, Virginia, back on the schedule.
Big old 12er. We haven't played them since White, the quarterback for West Virginia.
I want to say we played them since then. Pat White is who you're speaking
of. Yeah, Pat White. I was at the game, you know, when we beat them.
I'm pretty sure Lincoln and didn't Ruff play against West Virginia?
I don't think, did he?
Let me check on that.
Check it out.
The last meeting.
Yikes.
Oh, is this?
We played against Coach Mo. Played against
2017.
Yeah,
okay.
We did, and we got. I watched. That was a very frustrating game because I remember we had the ball in the red zone like three times and turned it over or something.
That was
crazy.
South Carolina that you're thinking about.
Oh, what thing?
Because we got throttled. We got throttled at West Virginia.
I guess I was trying to bring somewhat of a hope into that.
I do remember no Trayvon hope. Brown
and went nope.
Trayvon Brown had like a 90 plus yard touchdown reception in that game. And that was just about the only positive come out of that game for ECU.
Dang.
Bryce, 2027.
I'm liking these.
At South Carolina. Mm. Wake Forest at home. Love that game.
I'm ready. I wish we could play Wake Forest early. I wish we could skip pull from maybe BYU. And But can we do that?
Let's just copy paste.
Yeah.
Put them on up there.
Say, look, this is what y'all have.
At ODU, as Old Dominion is on the schedule from here till the end of time. And Georgia State, we owe them one for kicking our tails a couple years ago. 2028 NC State, Boise State at home. That's an attractive ticket, season ticket.
Yeah, oh, that'll be a big one.
And at Wake Forest in 2028.
Jeez.
2029, Old Dominion Liberty. 2030, at Old Dominion. 2031, Old Dominion.
Why are we so infatuated with Old Dominion?
I don't know.
Who's Poot? You know what? They need to give some people some say-so here. Like you.
Power to the people?
Power to the people. Yeah. It's like a dictatorship here on the schedule.
They
didn't, democracy.
They don't ask us anything.
Jeez.
Come on.
Tell you what. Things are changing around here.
I don't know if they are.
No,
it's a lot of Old Dominion.
Yeah.
A lot of ODU. Bryce, since we last spoke, we have had five ECU players enter the transfer
portal.
You know,
I kind of wanted to bring that up. I saw, you know, thanks once again, Pirate Radio social media, Malik Fleming leaving. I was like, well, daggone. But he wasn't a starter and all that jazz?
Yeah, he was like all-conference.
Why would you leave as an all-conference starter?
I don't know. I don't want to talk about rumors on the air, but just maybe
right.
Not happy with recognition. I don't know.
That's kind of a bummer. Like that, which my thing, I'm like, man, if I'm playing, I'm an all-conference player, you've established yourself, like with the team, now you got to start all over with 1 year left. Like, what if he doesn't even play?
I know.
You know, I mean, I guess that's a risk he's willing to take, but I don't know. That's a tough one there.
Yeah, and other names, Emmanuel Hickman, who played a lot on the D-line, transferred out. Rick DeBrew, who landed in a doghouse of sorts, it looks like, because he played a lot and then didn't play a lot this year. Taji Hudson, who came in as a quarterback, moved to receiver, never got on the field, got on the field in the bowl game, and was thinking, okay, maybe it's a little glimpse of the future, but he is hoping for greener pasture somewhere else. And there was Malik Fleming today. Who else am I missing? Was there one more, Chandler? I got to update my list so I can keep up with all this.
So I wonder if...
Oh, my guy, Andre Pegues. My spring darling from like 4 years ago who never played special teams.
Oh, he's transferred?
A receiver, yeah.
Oh, I got you.
Several of these guys have their degrees and are just kind of moving on, you know. But
yeah. I guess, I think I lost my train of thought. What was I doing? What was I about to say?
Well, we were talking about transfers. We were talking
transfers,
about Malik Fleming,
something about transferring. With the whole like... Do they take the risk entering the portal, or do you think they already have something lined up? That's what I was kind of thinking.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, when I was transferring to ECU, I mean, it was a guarantee that I was going to be, like, on the team.
So who did you
talk
to?
But I still had to, as far as, I think it was Coach Cadet.
So you're at Marshall.
I'm at Marshall talking to Sean, and I would talk to him weekly during that, you know, the whole game of highlight film, showed it to Coach Cadet. Coach Cadet saw it, moved it on, through thing, and it was like this weekly, hey, Sean, what do I need to do? This, that, and the other. And, then I did my whole transfer papers at Marshall, but I still had to take like a summer class for something because something didn't transfer from Marshall. Mm-hmm. So if I didn't pass that summer class, I would have been screwed.
You could go back to Marshall and you could go to ECU.
So, I mean, it was definitely a risk, which I was like, I don't do everything I could just to pass the classes I need and do what I could. You know, the football was already settled, but I had to get in there academically wise. So some one of these guys through the transfer portals that already like,
I think it might be different for different people, Bryce. I don't know how legal it is.
Because they got qualified to get into school, which
right.
If you're an athlete, you know, fortunately.
I think a lot of these guys probably enter without a net under the tightrope. I don't know if that's true or not. And
right.
Then there's others who are being recruited legally, illegally, I don't know.
Right.
Like, come over here, we got a spot for you.
I think on Coach 30, he always mentions the Air app. Is that a real thing?
Oh,
yeah. He always mentions the Air app. Like, is this real?
And Jones, who's the white guy? For those that don't know who we're talking about, it's a
Coach
guy on
30.
Twitter. Is that his name, Coach 30?
That's his Instagram. I know him as Coach 30. I guess he got Twitter. What's his daggum names he always uses?
Because I can't think of any of them.
He is really funny, and
oh, they're hilarious.
It kind of, I mean, it gets old like anything, because it's, but he's got some great writers.
He's done. I noticed he come up with it. I don't know. He does a dang good job. Davis is one he uses a lot.
Davis.
Yeah.
Connor. Connor's the white guy. And then you got Connor over here. He always thought if a quarterback throws interceptions, yeah, it's Connor.
Connor. I mean,
Davis.
He's kind of hitting. They're good.
Yeah.
Whoever wants to get a chuckle and like sports.
On Twitter, at MrGo30, and puts together these
pretty funny
these videos that you he, yeah, going over highlights.
It's pretty funny.
Bryce, actually, I think you might have turned me on to
it. I turned
Bryce.
You on to
it. How about that? Bryce turning me on to a social media phenomenon.
Yeah.
regarding sports.
I know.
Upset of the century there.
Ain't kidding.
All right, let's take a break. We'll come back. More to go. Pirate Radio Live with Bryce Williams.
I am curious about one topic, if we can.
Absolutely.
Noticing Holt Naylor's going into the NFLPA, but I guess we can do that on the way back.
Yeah, we'll talk about that. We will go Pirate Radio Outdoors and make you a winner. All that when we return after this.
Hey, Troy D here with my good friend Kelvin Rawls from Pest Tech. Kelvin, I just want to thank you and Chris and all the great folks at Pest Tech for such awesome service. You totally eliminated the mosquitoes in my backyard, plus the fire ant problem I was having in the yard.
Hey, you're certainly welcome, Troy. I have heard the same thing from all of our customers. With everyone being home, they want to enjoy the outside and being mosquito, fire ant, and pest free.
Enjoy all your property from the kitchen to the curb. Visit PestTechOfGreenville.com today for complete service.
Russell's Clothing in downtown Washington is celebrating 40 years in business. That means big savings for you on your favorite men's and women's clothing and accessories. As you would expect, Rhonda has slashed prices 40% on select merchandise. Outerwear, slacks, assorted sportswear, and shoes for the men. Dresses, sweaters, blouses, and outerwear for the ladies. Celebrate 40 years with us and save 40% while it lasts. We're here because of you, and we thank you, our friends and customers at Russell's Clothing in downtown Washington.
Have you experienced increased aches and pains recently? Have you heard of CBD? Hemp Garden is your premier CBD retailer in Eastern North Carolina. Do you find yourself having anxiety or in need of extra sleep support? Hemp Garden has a variety of Delta 8 and hemp-derived Delta 9 products that can assist with those issues. If you're unable to stop by the store, don't worry. Give them a call today at 413-6100 for a consultation, and they'll ship right to your door. Hemp Garden, 3040 South Evans Street in the Target Shopping Center in Greenville. Did you know time spent outdoors can help improve your children's health and bring balance to their life? The Outdoor Heritage Advisory Council invites you to join the PATCH program. This program is for any child under the age of 16 and includes activities like fishing, hunting, and hiking. These are just one of the many ways you can earn the exclusive patches from the Outdoor Heritage Council. For more information on how to sign up and get your adventure started, visit outdoorheritage.nc.gov.
Hey, Pirate Nation, this is Scott Harris with RE/MAX Preferred Realty. I've been in Greenville over 25 years. I'm a proud graduate of ECU. If you're looking to buy or sell a home, then give me a call today and let me help make your real estate process fun and easy. I keep it simple and explain the process every step of the way. My goals are your goals. There are no long-term contracts, and you always deal with me from start to finish. The right home starts with the right agent. Call me, Scott Harris, at 347-1857. Go Pirates!
This is Steven Igo. You've heard from me plenty on Pirate Radio Live and perhaps have read some of my work on hoistthecolors.net. Now, get an extension of our in-depth coverage on the Hoist the Colors podcast. From game previews to immediate post-game analysis to emergency podcasts for breaking news, we've got you covered. A cast of guest co-hosts from fans, former coaches, and other writers join me for two podcasts weekly to break down all things ECU athletics. Subscribe to Hoist the Colors now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or Google Podcasts.
It's bow time. You've probably heard folks say, don't call it a comeback. But at Bojangles, we don't like to beat around the bush. So when the sizzling, savory pork chop griller's back in all its tender, marinated chili lime glory, and you can get a pork chop griller combo for just $4.59, go ahead, call it a comeback. Get a legendary pork chop griller combo for just $4.59, only at Bojangles. It's bow time.
UBE
and PirateWear.com is excited to offer Pirate Nation the largest selection of new ECU merchandise and tailgate supplies ever. UBE has the best prices in town, so that makes UBE your one-stop shop for all things ECU. UBE does daily restocks of Champion, Adidas, and Under Armour. Don't forget to bring your young Pirates in to plunder the Crow's Nest, which is the only kids' store dedicated to ECU. Plenty of free parking uptown in Greenville. Visit them at PirateWear.com. Go Pirates!
You're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Bud Light, reminding Pirate fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Quality Equipment is your full-service John Deere dealer with 28 locations to serve you, and they're open in Winterville next to Sam's Club, or you can go online and visit qualityequip.com to find the location near you. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here is your host, Clip Brock.
Back with you, Pirate Radio Live, here on a Tuesday. Bryce Williams hanging out at the Pirate Radio Studios.
We are here.
Bryce, you mentioned Holden Ahlers coming off a Hula Bowl MVP over the weekend.
Yeah.
Is going to showcase his ability in another All-Star game. He'll be playing in the NFL PA Bowl in Los Angeles on the 28th.
Yeah, that's exciting. This man's played a lot of football since he was, I guess, even out of high school. And now he's playing two All-Star games, so, I mean, which is nice. I mean, I guess that can show some longevity and durability to, scouts and all that stuff. And then, you know, NFL PA in LA, so he gets, I mean, he's experiencing all sorts of things, even past college, which is exciting. It's definitely an exciting process. But so I'll have to tune in to
NFL Network.
NFL Network on the 28th, I'm assuming, of this month. I tell you, he must be soaking up these playbooks.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So Noah Henderson was in the Hula Bowl. I asked him about that yesterday. Maybe it's not that tough for a tackle, but I was like, you know, you go there and you're doing drills and stuff, but y'all have to play a game too. You have to know the calls and stuff. Is that difficult? He's like, no, it's just you kind of learn the words. It's kind of the same stuff over and over again. You just learn the different terminology.
Yeah.
For Holden, this is, he gets to play in another game, but more so, Bryce, is it just about being around like that week leading up to it, around scouts, coaches, like continuing network?
For sure. So, the thing they said to us in the Senior Bowl is honestly, the week of practice is more important than the game. So you want to have a really good practice, during that. And then honestly, it's depending on how they run it in NFLPA, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I had the Cowboys coaching staff, and my other buddy was with, they had the Jacksonville, and he said Jacksonville was like it was still a neat time, but the Jacksonville was kind of more relaxed and chill and stuff. Cowboys, my gosh, I felt like I was in training camp. I mean, it was a tough little gig there for that week, but everything leading up to it was exciting and everything you had to experience. The fact that Holden gets to go on a second, All-Star thing is, I'm sure he's having a great time and getting to, experience a lot of things. And then, to an NFLPA bowl game. So that's exciting and a big deal. And just allowing him to get, exposure. I'm sure, he's wanting to get as much exposure as he can and, prove himself. So it's congratulations to him to be invited and then to obviously get accepting that. So it's cool.
Noah, which, by the way, if you missed a great interview with Noah Henderson, really interesting guy, born in Iceland. His mother was in the military, so he traveled around, went a lot of different places. Didn't play football until he was a sophomore or junior in high school, he said. So, but we have that interview for you via podcast, YouTube, Facebook. Check that out. But he said that got some interesting questions, a lot of non-football questions, nothing too wacky. But he said that they wanted to know just, I guess, the kind of person he is, background, things like that. Like, do you remember that stuff?
Poke and prod you. Well, that was at the comment, but they poke and prod you. I mean, they ask all sorts of random questions. I mean, even
after the PA Bowl, or like after your All-Star Bowls, or this whole process, he's probably getting calls from scouts, and they'll ask everything, what your parents do, your brothers do, what do you like to do. I mean, they ask, they try and get to know you as best as they can. So it's an interesting process.
They try to know you as best you can by asking very odd questions that don't seem like they would get to know you those answers.
But oh, I know.
Oh, no. Bryce, you okay? Bryce, get him a water. Wait,
I do believe he has a cramp.
Do we have water?
I think going away.
Huh? You all right?
I think it's going away.
What's wrong?
Hey, is there any water in the fridge? Oh God!
Is there water?
I don't believe we have.
Oh no!
Dang it!
Bryce, we don't have any water.
Dadgummit!
You okay there,
Troy?
Bud?
Man, that's 2 weeks in a row you ain't got no water in the fridge.
You ain't had any water in 2 weeks?
2 weeks?
It's amazing you're alive.
Whew, I think it's going away.
Okay.
Where'd Chandler go?
All right.
He go get me some
Chandler,
water?
Get him some out of the back of the commode.
Yeah,
lift
commode, the tank.
Lift the back.
Fresh water.
And get him some water.
Oh, I think it's going away.
All right,
man,
good.
I really wish we had some water in the fridge during these shows to get dehydrating. Hot. I don't know when to take my sip because we don't have a clock.
It's raining outside. I can take a cup and like maybe
you put it under the gutter. Go put it under the spout.
All right, if you need filtered water, there's a fish tank.
Hold on, did you say I don't know when to take my sip because there's
a
clock?
Yeah, well, if you don't notice,
so,
we need
some water, but you and a clock as well.
And a clock. You know, if you look at my past shows, I take a sip of water every 5 minutes, but. One, we don't have water. Two, it's 5 o'clock. So I don't know what
This is Bryce's last week of Fire Radio.
It could be his last week on this earth if we don't have some water in him.
Some water.
Oh, my God. You scared the mess out of me.
Okay, I certainly hope that for social media purposes, this gets replayed as hot audio / hot video because to see him hop up out of the chair the way you did is hysterical, number one. Number two, I will say I did let powers that be know that we were out of water. So I don't know what happened. I actually thought we had water in the back, so I don't know what happened. So.
Did you tell them?
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest actors of our generation, Bryce Williams.
Wait, did he fake the entire thing?
That was a Bryce Williams production.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well done, sir.
Yeah.
Well
yeah, I had no
done.
Idea.
Yeah, I thought it was real.
You got him, Bryce. You got him.
And I just got a text. Tell Bryce I'm getting water tomorrow.
Here we go.
Tomorrow, Bryce. Can you hang on till then?
I'm going to try till next Tuesday. I don't have water just once a week from here.
This is where you get your water.
Oh, that needs to be served up.
Clip cramp.
That's what I heard was cramp, and
Bryce
I was like,
Williams,
"What,
man? What a job! Have you taken any like acting classes or anything?
No.
It had to be that time out in L.A. where you were with the Rams.
Yeah, you know, they did this little side gig during away games. You know,
Bryce cooked that up himself, man.
Wow. Yeah. Bravo.
I need some water, though. And a clock to time your sips. I never knew you timed your sips.
For his role in Cramp, Bryce Williams.
This is Bryce's first award.
I've seen a lot of people get cramps. All you do is straighten that leg, grab the hammy, and hop.
I hadn't had one like where you're like sleeping like middle of the night deal.
Like a Charlie horse.
Good God, man. Those are brutal.
Yeah.
And you have to get up and walk it out, and it's like, man.
Yep.
I get them in my calf sometimes, too. Oh.
I wish we could have seen Chandler's.
So what did you do when you went out in the hall? You knew he didn't have water, so what did you go do?
I went to go double check. I was, like, scared for his life. I was like, I got to find some water.
His face looked so concerning. So you know why that makes me feel good? I couldn't see Shirley, but I'm sure she was concerned.
We were all
laughing at you. Chandler was trying to help you out.
Yeah.
I mean, like I said, it's raining outside. Like, it might take a while, but I can get, like, a cup. And, like, put it under the gutter.
Give him a little sip by the end of the show. Every drop counts, Chandler. Give me a sponge.
I was a mixture of amused and
you're wringing it out in your mouth.
I was a mixture of amused and concerned.
Have you got a Walsh rag?
Wow, what a performance.
I was actually thinking, is my water bottle in the car? Because I might have some water in the car.
Get this man some H2O. All right.
Oh, boy.
So we will have water for Bryce next week?
I'm guessing so.
That's what
powers that be responded saying that they were going to get water tomorrow.
There you go, Bryce. Make a demand.
Don't have water, don't have a clock. it's the recipe for disaster for Bryce Williams.
All right, Shirley, let's open up the booty bag.
Booty, 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 booty everywhere. Booty, 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 booty everywhere.
All right, 317-1250. Not only do you get this acting display from Bryce Williams, you also get a treat from your friends at Pirate Radio. Shirley, what are we giving away today?
See, not only do you get like a mini movie if you join the cult of Pirate Radio, you also get free stuff.
Smash the like button.
$15 gift card to Wings Over Greenville.
Oh, man.
That helps with cramps, I heard.
Yeah, that would help me out. 317-1250, what caller?
12.
Caller 12, call now, 317-1250. We're back with more after this.
America's favorite light beer, Bud Light, is also the official beer of the ECU Pirates. When planning your fun times with family and friends, be sure to pick up some Bud Light at your favorite retailer. Bud Light carefully brews their beer to be perfect for anywhere there's fun. Because when there's fun, Bud Light is there. Always have fun, Pirate Nation, and always stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Go Pirates!
You've worked hard to make your business successful, and that's why it's really important to always have a bank that's in your corner when you need them. This is Chris Richards from First Bank, and our experienced team of local bankers includes Lee Watson, Ashley Capps, Bonner Latham, Josh Hooten, and Heath Nisbet. To get the business services that are right for your business, come and see one of our experienced team members at First Bank on Arlington Boulevard in Greenville. First Bank, together with our customers, we're creating a world where individuals and communities thrive. Member FDIC.
To keep your bodies active and engaged in the activities that you love, you need a good stretch. And at Bodies in Balance, that's the mission they follow to give you the best quality of life. With years of experience, the team at Bodies in Balance can create a stretch or massage program that's right for you. Visit them at 3101 South Evans Street in Greenville or schedule a home visit to receive a stretch or massage in the comfort of your own home. Call today at 916-4530 to schedule your first stretch consultation or massage appointment and check them out online at bodiesandbalance.com.
Chico's Mexican Restaurant is where the fiesta never ends. Grab your amigos and head to Chico's every Wednesday for shrimp tacos for $11.99. Plus, Wednesdays means all Mexican imports for just $2.99. Thursdays, enjoy your favorite beef, chicken, or vegetable fajitas for only $11.99. For Mexican food and fun, it's got to be Chico's Mexican Restaurant in downtown Greenville and online at chicosrestaurant.com. Chico's, where the fiesta never ends.
BMS Builders is your premier custom builder in Eastern North Carolina. With homes in Blackwood, Mills Creek, Dalton's Cove in Farmville, and Belmar in Aiden, they're constantly expanding. Now to Laurel Glen and Sarah's Way, plus the new duplex community at Abigail Trails. BMS Builders can build the home of your dreams. Just ask Dr. Dennis Ross in Greenville or ECU football coach Mike Houston. They built their homes, and they can build yours as well. Call 916-1578 for BMS Builders.
Hello, Eastern North Carolina. If you're looking for a great place to work with competitive pay and a multitude of advancement opportunities, Pitt County Schools is hiring. We employ over 3,500 people, and we're one of the largest employers in our community and region. Pitt County Schools is currently seeking teachers, bus drivers, school nutrition personnel, facility staff, custodians, clerical staff, and more. We offer advanced leadership opportunities for our educators and competitive pay for our skilled labor force. Come work for a diverse, thriving school system and be an important part of ensuring success for the students of Pitt County who are the future of Eastern North Carolina. To fill out an application, visit our website today at pittschools.org. That's pittschools.org. And remember, education is truly a team effort. Pitt County Schools, live and lead.
Hey,
Pirate Nation, Lindsey Gray here with Carolina Caliber. In 1960, my granddaddy started his firearm business right here in Eastern NC. Still family owned and operated, we have the area's largest selection for outdoor shooting sports and accessories and are one of the nation's top firearm dealers. At Carolina Caliber, we have everything you need from hunting, home defense, and personal protection, including a wide variety for ladies and youth. We buy, sell, and trade. It's a time-honored tradition. Visit us at Carolina Caliber on Fire Tower Road in Winterville.
This is Coach Gary Overton, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Bud Light, reminding Pirate fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Do you want to get rid of wrinkles, tighten and lift your skin, smooth your skin texture, erase veins and brown spots, and get rid of unwanted hair? Are you interested in Botox or filler? Contact the licensed professionals at Beauty Bar Medi Spa on Red Banks Road in Greenville. Free consultations available by calling 752-1406 or visiting beautybarmedispa.com. Enjoy your visit. Love your transformation. And congratulations to Randy Hobbs of Winterville. Picked up a $15 gift card to Wings Over Greenville. If you're looking for wings to be delivered to your home, Wings Over Greenville's got you covered with no third party needed. They have their own in-house delivery service, and be sure to try the all-new tender sandwiches by ordering ahead on their mobile app. And they are open till 3 a.m. on Fridays and Saturdays, so they have everything to cure those late night munchies. Give them a call at 758-9464. Wings Over Greenville, they deliver. Now let's head back into PRL. Here's Clip.
Back with you, Pirate Radio Live. We're going to have to start putting Bryce in more of our Pirate Radio videos. Who knew he had the acting chops?
That was outstanding.
He won a supporting actor award for...
Hey, boys, look out for that cougar.
Yeah, he won a supporting actor.
Have you had people come up to you, Bryce, and say, say the line, say the line?
Man, you know, not yet.
He's eating dinner with his wife at a restaurant. Bryce, could you just say it
say
one time?
Line. One time for my
hey,
kid.
Hey, boys, look out for that cougar.
Walking into that one in Farmville where we always bump into each other.
Oh, yeah.
Be like, oh, man, I can't even eat
peace. I know, geez.
Josh just tweeted, what are y'all doing to Big Bryce? Get that boy some water, and tweeted out the video. So there you go. Bryce, a soldiering through, man. We appreciate you doing it.
Of course. I'll do what I can.
Labor of love.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go Pirate Radio Outdoors, Bryce. I'm going to save you a little time this week. We had to speed round it last week.
So. Yeah, oh, yeah. Sorry. Well, we've been...
You talked about your duck hunting venture last week.
Last Tuesday.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we did that. I went home to Winston, obviously for mom's birthday, for the weekend. Well, I've been on the mission trying to find a. So I guess I've been doing a lot of prep this week, right? So I'm thinking, well, man, you haven't bought a firearm in a while, and I have a. It's a Harrington Richardson Topper Model 4, 158 and a 12 and a 20. I'm like, well, I need it in a 410. So I was like, well, let me call around to all the gun stores around here to see if they got them. Well, sure enough, nobody had them. I'm like, yeah, be kidding me. You know, it's a single shot 410, just old school thing. Well, fortunately, there was a gun show this weekend, and I said, well, Dad, you want to go to the gun show? And he said, well, of course. I'm like, this is what I got my eye on. So... trying to speed up a little bit, you know, I'm walking through the vent, through the tables. We get there right when it opens, made my circle around the perimeter tables. Sure enough, there's one right there. And I'm, oh, that's what I want. But I haven't seen the middle section. You know, I haven't been through the middle section yet, right? And so I was like, man, what will you take on it? We worked up a price. He said, well, I'll text my cousin, and I'll see if he takes his price. If so, I'll put it on the table. I'll kind of make my rounds. I'm gone for like an hour looking out for everything else. Have not found a single one. Long story short, came back. Thank goodness that guy still had it for sale. Purchased that because that was the only one out of that whole, because that's the fairgrounds Wednesday, like one of the big arenas. And that was the only model 140, 158 and a 410, you know, 410 single shot out of the whole thing. And I purchased it. So,
by the way, you had an off-air story last week about trying to purchase something that was for sale and you thought you had a deal to make that purchase and it didn't go through.
Yeah.
So when you're telling me that story, I'm like, I hope that didn't happen to him again.
No, thank goodness. Thank goodness. Because yeah. I was trying to, I should have just bought it then.
Yeah.
The whole time I was walking around, I said, man, if I'm going to let, because there's only a $20 difference from what I agreed on versus right. what he did. And I'm like, if I let $20 make this sale not happen, because I'm like, I'm going to go find what else is out there. Because obviously a bird in the hands were two in the bush. And I had the bird right there. And I was like, I'm going to try to find a better deal. And sure enough, there was not one single thing even close to it. I don't think another 410 in that whole center section of the gun show. But thank goodness it was still there when I got there, and I scooped it right up. So that was a good thing. So obviously I can use that for squirrel, rabbit. I may get bold, because it's a full choke. I may get bold and see if I can shoot a turkey. You never know. And the single shot makes it cool. And so that's, a sort of prep thing. And then obviously we got the new property. My father-in-law bought the new property last year. And I've been prepping it for the deer. And we are now cutting one big main road through the middle of the property. That way I can access it more. One, we can, we can access it more for riding and whatever, and also more deer stand locations. So that's going on yesterday. He wasn't able to get there today. Should be done.
These are like your off-season workouts.
Because
if you don't get ready during the off-season, then you ain't going to be ready when it comes around.
Yeah, exactly. So that's going on. And so then he's going to do some stuff in the shooting lanes I got now so I can prep that for getting soil, good soil in there for food plots. And, hey, the prep starts now, Prep starts now. So that's what's going on. Just a lot of prep work, but hopefully we'll be duck hunting, goose hunting this week, or fishing. So hopefully have some live action. So we'll see.
All right, Bryce, Pirate Radio Outdoors.
Yep.
Is it gonna ever get cold? Probably February or something.
I would hope this today. My buddy went duck hunting, which wasn't cold, but of course it was raining. Wind was blowing, cloudy. Wouldn't it be a perfect day for duck hunting? Sure enough, they shot the ducks up. Two buddies did, actually, and of course I didn't go. I'm always a day late, dollar short sometimes. I almost say that all the time, but I'm like, I'm duck hunting when I should be fishing. I'm fishing when I should be duck hunting. But I gotta take it when I can.
Yeah, there you go.
So are y'all ready for snow? I don't know. Do you like snow? You just want to be
I
cold.
Like it one time, I guess, and then just to see it, say we saw it.
Are we expecting to have some this year?
Well, I mean,
maybe
there were supposed to be some flurries over the weekend.
I feel like February is going to just get probably brutal for a week or something. But this week, tomorrow the high is 68, Thursday 75.
What in the world?
Yeah, snow flurries this weekend?
No.
Oh.
So it's going to remain mild and hottish.
But going out to Clark LeClair Stadium.
Oh yeah.
Oh, it's
that
colder.
First month.
Yeah.
Brutal.
Mid February is going to be
brutal. Yeah. The jungle guys, they have their heaters and stuff.
Yeah.
And everybody's just wrapped around those heaters, and it's brutally cold.
Yeah.
Let's take our last break. We'll come back a little bit more for you here on a Tuesday edition of Pirate Radio Live. We're back after these words.
Jeff Stein, our special guest from Brown & Wood. Hey, Jeff, electric cars are coming. What's that mean for Brown & Wood customers?
For the customers, like it or not, EV is coming. We've installed 5 electric vehicle chargers here at the dealership. We have the all-new Cadillac Lyriq coming first of 2024, and we've just seen the first reservation for the new Sierra EV.
People are interested in electric vehicles. How can they get up with you?
They can visit us at brownandwood.net or 329 Southwest Greenville Boulevard. Brown & Wood, 4 brands, 3 generations, 2 rooftops, and 1 goal. To make sure you leave a happy customer.
Country Mart has been locally owned and operated for over 40 years and is your premier country store, serving the best cheese biscuits and country food around. Country Mart is open every day and has 2 locations in Bethel on Highway 11 and in Stokes on Highway 903. Both Country Mart locations are top-of-the-line fuel stations, serving Shell gas, including 93 ethanol-free high-octane gas. Country Mart, fueling you up with great food in your engines with great gasoline. Go Pirates!
Do you want to get rid of wrinkles, tighten and lift your skin?
smooth your skin texture, erase veins and brown spots, get rid of unwanted hair and under-eye fat pads? Are you interested in Botox or filler? Contact the licensed professionals at Beauty Bar Medi Spa for a free consultation and ask about our newest technologies and treatments. Learn more at beautybarmedispa.com, Red Banks Road, Greenville. Enjoy your visit, love your transformation, and go Pirates!
When it comes to hauling dirt, asphalt, or stone, you can trust the pros at First and Goal Hauling Incorporated. They have a fleet of dump trucks ready to get the job done. And best of all, it's owned and operated by ECU football alum Dakota Marshall. When you have a big job and you need it done right, count on First and Goal Hauling, where it's a touchdown every time. Keep up with Dakota Marshall and First and Goal Hauling by following them on Facebook today.
Great. It's 30 degrees in here. This is going to be a cold night.
No one's coming out this late.
I'm on firewood.
Dad! I'll put hot coals in our socks for bedtime.
Mom!
Hi, I'm from Delcor Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing. Got an email about your heat being out?
That was me. I sent it from my phone.
I think your socks are on fire.
Ah! Call Delcor today to get a new system installed for less than $100 a month. Offer expires soon. Go to DelcorInc.com. Monthly fee based on new system financing is 9.9% APR for 120 months. Call Delcor for details.
Great food, great atmosphere, and great service is Ottavola Market Cafe. Ottavola is simply a restaurant that focuses on that, being a great restaurant. There's something for everyone at Ottavola. The menu offers a variety of great choices like pastas, pizzas, sandwiches, soups, salads, and seasonal rotating selections. Lunch or dinner, Ottavola is always the right call. Call ahead and get Ottavola to go, or stop by the bar for a drink with friends. It's simple. Come and eat at Ottavola Market Cafe, Red Banks Road next to Food Lion, and ottavolamarket.com. Ottavola, Pirates supporting Pirates.
The convenience of Pitt Greenville Airport is waiting just outside your front door. Service is back, so you're connected to destinations worldwide through flights from American Airlines. Plan your next trip. Book your flights today at flypgv.com or aa.com.
Avoid the long check-in lines and congestion at the big airports and fly local at PGV. Fast, convenient, and close to home, PGV has American Airlines flights perfect for your next trip. Book today at aa.com. PGV, where the Pirates fly.
The best burgers around. Everyone loves a thick, juicy, and fresh burger. Tiebreakers in Greenville, plus the all-new Tiebreakers in Winterville, do real burgers better than anybody. So don't just go to any burger-themed restaurant chain. It's time to break the chain and eat local. Tiebreakers, real burgers at its best.
Everybody loves burgers.
This is Brian Bailey, host of The Brian Bailey Show, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Bud Light, reminding Pirate fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. It was a rough day for the Dow today. It dropped 391 points, finished out at 33,910. The NASDAQ was up 15, however, at 11,095, and the S&P was down just 8 points, closed out the day at 3,990. That's your Wells Fargo Advisors financial report. For a personal look into investing, call Wells Fargo Advisors today at 756-6900 in Greenville. Wells Fargo Advisors LLC, member SIPC. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Clip.
All righty. Getting ready to wrap it up here on a Tuesday, taking a look at the Buccaneer Music Hall scoreboard presented by DuBuck.
DuBuck.
I think I have a game highlighted, Chandler. And I probably would have highlighted the previous games NC State played and picked against them and lost. And I might go right back to that well tonight because they're 6-point favorites at Georgia Tech. Now, I know Georgia Tech isn't good. They're 8-9, 1-6 in conference play. But NC State, 14-4, 4-3. They've won three in a row. Like, it just feels like this would be when they lose, right? If you look at the history,
this could be the down. This is gonna be the disappointing game,
right? They beat Duke. They beat who'd they beat? Another ranked team, I believe, over the weekend.
Our guys,
the U. They beat Miami
on Saturday.
So now they play this lowly Georgia Tech team on the road. They're favorites on the road.
We talk about this in football, too. Like, they go on a streak of games, yeah, big wins, and we're like, all right, there's got to be a disappointing game for the Wolfpack. In this case, I think it could be tonight against the Yellow Jackets.
And I don't know anything about Georgia Tech. I'm going to be honest. I'm just going historically NC State let down. So give me Georgia Tech plus six.
Well, I don't want to make you do that. But I was just going to say, what's their future schedule? Maybe there's one better than Georgia Tech, but it could be tonight.
No, I mean, if there's going to be a letdown, it's probably going to be against this team. Let's see if they have a look ahead coming up. Only at North Carolina this weekend. This is a perfect setup for a loss tonight for State. They're looking ahead. Give me Tech plus the maybe money line.
Oh, baby!
I mean, come on now. Houston in action tonight. Good game at Tulane as the number one team in the country. Houston will go to New Orleans. Kansas at Kansas State. Texas at Iowa State. And, of course, we talked about Clemson 7-0 in the league. They'll try to get to 8-0 tonight when they take on Wake Forest. Wake Forest, a four-point favorite at home against those 19th-ranked Clemson Tigers. Bryce, thanks for hanging out. Hopefully we'll have some water for you next week, man.
I'm parched and cramped.
Yeah, hopefully you make it. Do I need to follow you home to make sure you make it?
It was my damn throttle leg.
leg.
Well,
I was wondering about that. I was like, please don't be the throttle leg.
It's the throttle leg and the brake leg.
What's wrong with Bryce? He hurt his throttle leg.
Got a throttle leg injury. We'll see you next week, Bryce. Enjoyed it.
Okay, thank y'all for having me.
Shirley Rhodes, Chandler Honeycutt. We'll see you fine folks Wednesday, 3 o'clock for an all-new edition of Pirate Radio Live. We'll talk to you then. So long, everybody.
Thanks for listening to Pirate Radio Live, an exclusive presentation of the voice of the Pirate Nation. This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930 and 104.1 FM Washington. This is the Pirate Radio Podcast.
Welcome in.